black person?
Sir, no, I would not.
Have you ever said the N-word?
I'm not.
Come on, be the truth. We on the truth.
Unfiltered and unfazed. This is the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth and The Truth App.
The reason I believe the racism is getting worse is because whites know that they will be outnumbered in about 20, 21 years. They're going to be outnumbered.
Hey, Tory, man. How are you doing, brother? I'm actually from India. We brown people can totally relate with you. Sometimes it's like, did that just happen to me?
We have to not let the government mind efforts either.
That cop ain't never been brought to the public because he ain't normal, and he may not even exist no more.
Say no more. Release the video.
You know, you keep on doing what you're doing, man. You're going to take over this talk radio, man. Just keep on focusing on what you're focusing on. I wish you a lot of love.
God bless you, brother.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio in Milwaukee, here is Tory Lowe.
Wendy boy, go crazy.
Justice Wisconsin, the truth. The most requested advocate in the state. 101.7 FM. The movement continues. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Milwaukee, stand up, stand up. It's Tory Lowe, the truth, from one to four. We about that action, so tap in and let's go. We want that justice, we want all the smoke. From Monday through Friday, trying to bring the city hope. Yeah, Tory Lowe from one to four, Monday through Friday, let's go. We about that action from the block, and we ready, let's go. Tap in, and it ain't no holding back. We ready, we ready.
101.7 The Truth. Tory Lowe, Tory Lowe Show, live from American Family Insurance Studio at the Avenue, and I'm here for the action.
And I'm but that action.
And I want all the smoke.
Who wants to smoke today?
Salute to my brothers and sisters on the front lines. The marathon continues. How you doing, DJ Brother Z?
It's Thursday.
And how y'all doing out there in Radio Land? Truth Nation. Thank you for joining me this Thursday, March 28th, 2024. And we're going to get right into the show. We're going to get right into the show today. There's a lot of talk about this referendum, and I know until we had a vote, I guess we're going to keep talking about it. And it's people weighing in on both sides, but I guess that was a meeting with Aisha Carr, and let me get some water. I don't even know if that made it better or not, but NPS is the hot topic right now, and nearly 6,000 students, they're saying, in this new report that just recently came out, that, and this came out March 14, 2024, suspensions are up in Milwaukee Public Schools. Nearly 6,000 students have been suspended in Milwaukee Public Schools so far this year, with black students making up about 80% of the suspensions. 80%. And this is something that we got to talk about. They say just under 50% of the district's 67,495 students are black, 28% are Hispanic, and 9% are white. And is this an issue? I'm just saying, is when we talk about more money, is the money going where it should be? Is it being invested in the right things? And I know we use trigger ideas like arts, music, you know, but I'm talking about tutoring. I'm talking about extra mentorship. I mean, like, are we really getting to the core of what's wrong with NPS? And I'm an alumni of NPS. I'm from North Division High School in the 53206. I was popular too. I was handsome. I'm still handsome. But I was extremely popular because I played football. I was an advocate. I was a deacon at church when I was in high school. You know, a lot of people that know me from high school and the way I am now, it's not that much difference. It's just I'm older. Like, the people that know me from North know me for helping and being a positive person in high school. At least after my freshman year. I mean, I wasn't bad my freshman year, but I had a huge fight my freshman year. And then during that suspension, I got in church. I got involved in church. So when I came back, it was like a 360. Like, they was like, who is this guy? I had started going to church, and shortly after that, I was a deacon, a young deacon walking around North Division holding the Bible. I remember one day I was walking through the hallway, and a student hit the Bible out of my hand, slapped the Bible, slapped all my books out of my hand, and everybody thought I was going to beat him up because I was a star football player. I was one of the star football players. So when the young man knocked all the books out of my hand, everybody was watching to see how much Jesus did I have in me at that point. And then so I picked up,
bruh.
I picked up my stuff off the ground. I picked up my books. I gathered myself because I wanted to knock them out. I almost backslid. They call it backslide. I almost backslid with the backslap. I almost backslapped. But I said, you know what? I said, don't knock my books out of my hand no more, or I'm gonna be forced to do something to you that I probably don't want to do.
Are you out of your damn mind?
Right. So I talked to him so calmly that the young man apologized, and then everybody around me who witnessed what happened went and told everybody that Tory must be a real Christian person, because I handled the situation in the manner where it wasn't no drama. And so everybody started coming to me for resolution after that. And when I was in high school, or, you know, I was one of those kids that people can come in and get some good information or good affirmations from. But all I'm saying is NPS is near and dear to my heart because I am a product of NPS, even though I had a hard time going through North Division. I had a hard time dealing with the situations that was going on with the distractions and with a lot of my friends in high school at that time were getting shot or going to jail. I was told when I walked into North Division that I would either end up dead or in jail by the time I was 19.
Damn.
This is what they told me. This is what they told me.
A teacher?
Assistant teacher. And he was an assistant football coach. This is what they told me. A lot of pressure to put on a young freshman, you know what I mean? But that's why I say, when we talk about putting the money in the right places, that's what I'm talking about. And we've given money to NPS, and we've listened, and we voted, and we've done this before. So I'm wondering, where's the money going and why things are not improving? That's my concern. That's my concern. And I haven't seen much change since I was in high school. I think it's getting worse. Back when I was coming up, it was probably two or three class clowns. It was probably two or three. And they would always act a fool, and the teacher would send them out of the class. Now, when my son comes along and goes to Bradley Tech, and I go up there to Bradley Tech because I'm an active parent, and these kids was going crazy. Like, I'm like, I'm a parent sitting in class. Y'all really finna do this? They did not care. And you know what one of the students had said when I was sitting in the class? You know, my son, I teach my son not to, you know, be disruptive and get his work done. We was big on don't embarrass the family. Don't embarrass the family. I was big on that. But when I came to class, my son was doing his work. I was sitting in the back of the class. Don't you know the students? It was more class clowns in the class, in his class, acting up. I couldn't believe it. And you know what one of the students told the teacher? The student told the teacher, stop acting funny because you don't normally act like that. You don't normally act the way you acted, and you only acting like that because Maurice's dad is in the class. So what the teacher was doing, so the teacher was acting on his best behavior because I was in the classroom. And the students was acting up, and they told the teacher he fronting because he usually with the mess. And I just started laughing. And, you know, when we was coming up, when the parents came to the classroom, we act like we was doing our work. Like, okay, it's a parent here. Let's not act a fool. Well, when my son was going to tech, that wasn't the case. And I'm going to tell you right now, the teacher probably was more with more drama. And he was acting on his best behavior because I was in the class. And the students called him out on it. Forward to now, my son is out of high school. And you see now that I'm reading this article that 50% of the kids getting suspended is black kids. So you telling me these kids don't want to learn? You telling me these kids just going to school and just want to act crazy? Or are you saying all these kids got mental health issues and special ed problems? I ain't believing that. Now, I do believe it's lead coming through the fountain. We do got tests where a lot of the schools in NPS had lead in the fountain, in the bubbler. That's a fact. I believe it's lead poisoning before I believe these kids, all these kids coming to school and they don't want to learn. Are we applying the money in the right space? That's all I'm saying. Is the money going where it need to go? Or is they fattening their pockets? Is the administration fattening their pockets and teachers is trying to get whatever crumbs they could get?
Rich gang.
You know, whatever little crumbs they could get for their salary. And then you got all these contractors that's contracting with NPS that got contracts that's coming. So we got all these people rotating around these kids, and you telling me it ain't improving? And we continue to pour money into the NPS system, hoping that we can get better outcomes, and they consistently coming back asking for more money. All the administration driving Mercedes Benz and you know, got these high salaries. I'm just interested. I'm interested. I want to know. I just got more questions. I just got more questions than answers. That's all. Hey, look, when we come back, we're going to have more discussion, Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
And that's Tory Lowe, bringing you all the action and all the smoke. Don't touch that dial. The Tory Lowe Show will be right back on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Tune in to the award-winning 101.7 The Truth this Saturday, 10 a.m. for another episode of Diversity and Excellence powered by Erie Insurance, hosted by me, Dr. Ken Harris, and Fred Johnson, Vice President and Wisconsin State Manager for Erie Insurance. Listen back to some of the best conversations Fred and I have had over the last 6 months about setting yourself up for professional success with Erie Insurance and also protecting the assets that matter to you the most by doing business with Erie Insurance. So again, don't miss Diversity and Excellence powered by Erie Insurance this Saturday, 10 a.m. on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Don't you wish your life came with a warning app?
Stop. That dog does not want to be petted.
Just a little heads up before something bad happens.
Move your coffee cup away from your computer.
Oh, no.
So you can have more control.
Stop. You're texting your boss by mistake.
Uh-oh. Well, life doesn't always give you time to change the outcome, but prediabetes does. With early diagnosis and a few healthy changes like managing your weight, getting active, stopping smoking, and eating healthier, you can stop prediabetes before it leads to type 2 diabetes. It's easy to learn your risk. Take the 1-minute test today at doihaveprediabetes.org.
Warning, the cap is loose on that ketchup.
Ugh. Don't wait. You have the power to change the outcome. Visit doihaveprediabetes.org today. That's doihaveprediabetes.org. Brought to you by the Ad Council and its Prediabetes Awareness Partners.
If anyone knows the joy of rescuing animals, it's me. Just ask my rescues, who are all very important members of my family. Your life can also be forever changed by adopting a shelter pet. And it's not just about happiness your pet gets from finding a loving home, but that which you'll get from bringing them into your life. The heroes at American Humane have been helping animals for more than 140 years, whether it's rescuing animals caught in disasters, ensuring the safety of animal stars on screen, or protecting our planet's endangered species. They go above and beyond to further their mission and make the world a kinder place for animals. Please consider adopting a shelter pet and support American Humane. You can learn more at AmericanHumane.org.
Brought to you by American Humane.
Here at the new 101.7 The Truth, we aim to be a staple in Milwaukee's Black community. We are committed to partnering with local organizations and supporting Black-owned businesses. We are proud to call Milwaukee our city and promise to be a positive reflection of our community. We look forward to celebrating Black culture and excellence with you every day as we make history and continue to uplift the voices in our city. Join us for the journey at the new 101.7 The Truth, founded by Gruber Law Offices, Milwaukee Black Talk.
You are listening to the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
He was once a thug from around the way.
Slim Thugger, my God.
Seven The Truth, Tory Lowe Show, DJ Brother Z on the ones and twos. We got some talk to text, DJ Brother Z, on the subject of NPS before we move on to our next story out of New York. I want to read some of these talk to text while we fresh on the subject. 8200 says, I think NPS should be audited, and they're asking for this amount, but they are not giving a clear plan to the people about how they are going to utilize the 200 and whatever million. The only thing I keep hearing is art and music class teachers, you don't need 252 million for that. You could do art and music class in the classroom with the teacher. The school is mismanaging the current funds. They have the school board leaders want a raise, just like the mayor with his 15% raise increase. I'm voting no. Hey, we want results. You can't just keep piling on and can't show nothing for it. Because
they just got money and have no results to prove that the money that they got works.
They got millions. All I see is brand new cars, luxury vehicles. 9591 says, if the children are an image of their parents and their parents don't do anything in school, they won't either. It is not a priority. I guess they blaming the parents.
It's everybody to blame at this point.
Hey, when in doubt, blaming the parents is the way out. Hey, you can't argue with that. The apple don't fall too far from the tree.
Birds of a feather flock together.
Hey. But sometimes you got to overcome. You got to be that first generation. You got to be that first generation graduate. And that's why you got the teachers up in there for, to find that, to find inspiration in the kids, to try to get them out of it. But I want to head to New York. There is a situation that I think we should be concerned about. Women randomly getting punched in the face in New York, just at random. Guys walking up to women while they looking in their cell phone, smacking them in the face and running off.
Damn.
Let's see what's going on in New York.
The stories are harrowing.
I was literally just walking, and a man came up and punched me in the face. Oh, my God. It hurts so bad.
College student Michaela Tonato says she was just leaving class in Manhattan.
So I just got punched in the face walking home.
He hit me right on my cheekbone. This doesn't hurt as bad as the concussion does.
She says she didn't see it coming.
You've got some visible signs. You have the black eye, but yeah. Michaela, emotionally, how are you feeling?
No, it's been really, really hard. I think it hits me in waves. A lot of crying because it was really, really scary.
The NYPD confirms it is looking into at least four similar cases, like the one shared on social media. In one of them, police say a 40-year-old man has been arrested and charged with assault.
I was punched in the head in New York City, in Times Square.
But the police have not linked the cases to the videos. In recent days, dozens of accounts of alleged assault have popped up online. NBC News has not been able to verify all the videos. The troubling stories surfacing at the same time there has been a rash of violent crimes on the city's busy subways. In response, the National Guard has been brought in to search bags, and 1,000 additional NYPD officers are now riding the trains, too. But the mayor pushing back on the idea that crime is rampant in this city and expressing concerns that social media is stoking fears.
I know a city out of control because I visit some of them in this country. This is not one of them.
77% of Americans believe crime is on the rise, according to a Gallup poll. Misdemeanor assault is up 10% from this time last year in New York City. But in most places, the FBI says violent crime is down.
I'm really scared to go back to school. I've just been delaying it as long as possible, but I'll have to go back eventually.
Hey, that's enough. I mean, like, we got the point. Like, people are randomly punching women in the face. Now, I don't know what a woman did to these men, or that something happened where they got scarred to where they just going and just doing this. But New York, it's a lot of strange stories coming out of New York. And there's a huge exodus going on in New York, too. A lot of people are leaving New York, moving out. You know, so all I'll say is this. Y'all be on the lookout, because usually it starts in New York. Like, sometimes trends take place in New York and then it starts going viral. I hear a little feedback in my headphones, DJ Brothers. I don't know what that is. But I'll tell you this. If it ever make its way to Milwaukee, y'all got to be careful, because these women in Milwaukee, they will beat you up. They will go toe-to-toe with you. I mean, if you think that's going to come here and trend where you're going to smack a woman walking around Milwaukee, you're going to learn today. They do not play in Milwaukee. These women is built like that. Can you imagine somebody trying to hit Liz Brown and trying to run away? And Liz Brown will track you down. You will not get away. You is not.
What's like that, Liam?
You gonna get handled rough
or whatever? Yeah, she's right. Gonna hunt you down.
Yeah, like, hey, and it's a thousand Liz Browns out here. I'm trying to tell you, they is not having it. They is not having it here in Milwaukee. But like I said, just be careful. This is another thing that's trending, and you know how people do the copycat stuff, and they saying these people, these men that's hitting these women is running so fast that when they hit them, they get away. So they not being caught. And they got some video footage. There's a video footage going around of a man that's randomly punching women in the face on the subway. And I mean, I'm talking about clotheslining women. After he, I mean, you know, these women sometimes weigh 110 pounds, 120 pounds, you know, and he and they just clubbing them. So hopefully that trend don't take place and catch on anywhere else. But I'm going to tell you, they got something for you right here in Milwaukee. They got something for you. And you know what? That may be your last day on earth. If that ever catch on around here, because I done seen some women go head to head with the best of them. So, hey, look, when we come back, we going to have a pop culture report, Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
The Empowerment Small Business Loan Program, we're talking about up to $5 million, which for small business owners, we need that. That's like payroll, that's resources. So can you just let us know, what is the program and why is this lending program so important to Old National Bank?
Years ago, our CEO, Jim Ryan, this program is his brainchild. He was working with Roland Shelton, who you know, Denise, out of Evansville. And they identified that African-American business owners, Hispanic business owners, Native American business owners, as well as women business owners, had a difficult time in obtaining financing from the traditional credit partners. So we went out, created a program, launched it last year, 2023. And so far last year, we have helped over 100 successful minority and women-owned businesses with about $25 million in loans. We've already started this year with almost $8 million in approvals, again, geared toward minority business owners and women business owners that normally had difficulties in obtaining traditional credit finance.
Attention, families. Milwaukee Public Museum wants to remind you that Kohl's Thank You Thursdays are in full swing. Receive free access to MPM's permanent exhibits on the first Thursday of every month. Milwaukee Public Museum would like to thank Kohl's for their support and making this program possible. Visit MPM's website today for more information and to book your reservations. mpm.edu/KTYT. That's mpm.edu/KTYT.
One call, that's all. Gruber Law Offices. If you or a loved one is ever injured in an accident, you should hire a law firm with proven results who stands up for victims and takes the burden off your shoulders. Gruber Law Offices has been serving our community for over 35 years and provides the best care, service, and consulting with no fee until they win your case. Visit gruber-law.com or contact them at 414-276-6666. Make one call, that's all, with Gruber Law Offices.
No young person should ever have to worry about having a safe place to sleep at night, or a warm meal to eat, or whether anyone cares about them.
But the reality is, 1 in 10 young adults will experience a form of homelessness this year.
But the good news is, there's an organization making a big difference. Covenant House.
For over 50 years, Covenant House has been helping youth in crisis and giving them the support and the tools they need to succeed in life.
I have no words to express how Covenant House changed my life. They just really genuinely just wanted to help me succeed, and I'm succeeding.
When youth who are experiencing homelessness have a hot meal, a safe place to sleep, and love, most of all love, they can overcome heartbreaking challenges, and their lives are transformed.
Covenant House is changing the lives of young people in cities across America.
To learn more, go to covenanthouse.org today. Thank you for caring.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Alex Celez. Coming off their loss to the Lakers on Tuesday night, the Bucks are in New Orleans to take on Zion Williamson and the Pelicans this Thursday night. Tip-off is scheduled for 7, with coverage over on WTMJ beginning at 6:30. The Brewers' first regular season game has been postponed due to rain this Thursday afternoon, as they are set to take on the New York Mets on Friday afternoon now. Freddy Peralta expected to take the mound for the Brewers versus Jose Quintana. First pitch is scheduled for 12:40, with coverage over on WTMJ beginning at 12:05. Finally, Marquette continues to prepare for their Sweet 16 matchup on Friday night versus NC State. Tip-off is scheduled for 6:09, with coverage over on 94.5 beginning at 5:30. This sports update brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown team's member, FDIC.
This is the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
So, I typed a text to a girl I used to see, saying that I chose this cutie pie with whom I want to be. And I apologize if this message gets you down. Then I CC'd every girl that I'd CC round town. And hate to see y'all frown, but I'd rather see her smiling. Witness all around me, true. But I'm no island, peninsula maybe. Makes no sense, I know crazy. Give up all this that's in my lap, no looking back. Spaceships don't come equipped with rear view mirrors. They dip. As quick as they can.
101, Saving the Truth, Tory Lowe Show. Pop Culture Report brought to you by Truth Nation, social media sensation, Jason Smith in the building.
Yes, sir. We right here, man.
Hey, how you doing, Jason Smith?
I am doing absolutely amazing. How about you?
You got any updates on what's going on with Diddy?
It's something new.
Because it's something new going on every day.
Not even every day. It's something new going on every hour.
What?
So what just recently came out, what I didn't know much about, I was actually talking to DJ Brother Z about this literally right after I left the Pop Culture Report yesterday. And we found out that Young Miami from City Girls.
His girl
from City Girls. You know,
somebody said he was a beard.
Yeah, hey.
She was a beard for Diddy.
No, she had to be. She probably most likely was because she is now getting thrown into the lawsuit by Lil Rod.
What?
By Lil Rod. The same lawsuit saying that she has been transporting pink cocaine. And
what's pink cocaine?
That's crack smoking crazy is what that is.
I'm trying to find out what is pink cocaine. Because I remember looking it up and I saw that Diddy and his drug mule, like they had these little packets of pink powder, pink crystals in there, and I'm trying to figure out what is that. So what it is it's ecstasy and cocaine mixed.
What?
Man, they was getting. So it's a story that he was getting ready to go out and speak in front of some people, and he didn't have his drugs, and the drug mule brought the wrong drugs. So he called Young Miami to hop on the private jet, fly to wherever they was. I think that he was in Miami to fly there to deliver the pink cocaine.
What?
So this story is just getting crazier and crazier, and that makes sense.
Is this allegedly or?
So this is all allegedly. Remember.
Okay.
Remember.
Yeah, because we still got to go through the court process.
Exactly.
Right?
They still going through, fishing through the evidence they found with the home invasion. So we don't. This is all just. This is allegedly. Or I'm going off of court documents. I'm just going off of the stuff that was put out to the public.
Well, the woman that got shot in the club back when it was Shine, Diddy, and J-Lo.
Uh-huh.
She coming out saying that Diddy was the one that pulled the trigger.
Man.
And at that time, they blamed it on Shine. She said she looked Diddy right in the eye.
Yeah. They had people.
Before the gun went off, and it was Diddy, but Shine took the rap for it.
He had people do that. He keep people around him.
Mules.
Allegedly. He keep people around him, so you know. What I'm
I need me some
take,
mules around
they can
me
just take
just
the
case.
Fall. Just in
I mean,
case.
So what is the life of a mule? I mean, all I know is the mule is the one that get to enjoy some of the good life until the police kick in the door. They got to take the rap if it's a dirty gun, if it's some drugs. they got to take the rap. So they keep the life of a mule is like. It's extravagant on the first thing. I'm talking about if you're dealing with people who got money.
Real money.
The life of a street mule is terrible.
Yeah, that's horrible. The hood rich
right.
mules, they not.
Like,
no,
if you just
nothing.
On the block and you're a mule, like, you may need to reconsider your career. You need to probably go and get a trade, get a two-year trade or something like that.
Yeah, because you clowning.
But if you're a mule for Diddy, you get to go on the private jets. You get to, you might be like an Igor type person. Where you got to, you know, do what you told. But at the same time, these mules are willing to take that chance on that level.
Because of money. Money, and then not only that, lifestyle, obviously. You rolling with Diddy. He
right.
got you, like you saying, in a private jet. And, like, his drug mule was a...
A Syracuse basketball
exactly,
player.
Exactly, a college basketball player. So, damn. Come on now. He When I was in college, man, who in college don't need money? Especially
right.
you got somebody, you got Diddy offering you most likely.
That was before the NIL deals.
Yeah, and he probably wasn't like a star or nothing, so he probably wasn't even getting the NIL deal. So he like, hold on, I got Diddy. It's easy for him to transport the drugs.
Right.
So he like, man, Diddy calling me to just bring him some drugs that I'm already getting?
I'm already using these.
That's nothing, you know what I'm saying? I'm already on that. I'm
right.
already passing this out to other people.
Right.
And I got this dude who worth $900 million want me by his side at all times, and all I got to do is carry drugs and give it to him? Hey. So life for a drug mill and that life
right.
is probably kind of good
until you get caught.
Right. until the feds come knocking.
Until suspicions start to occur.
Well, they arrested the mule.
Yeah, he got mugshot and all.
So, in his face, he looked like somebody that, you know, you wouldn't even detect. He actually looked like somebody you wouldn't check first.
Exactly.
And I think that's why they picked him.
Right.
Exactly. They picked a white boy from in college.
White boy. Looked like he's from a small town.
You know, he ain't worried about that. But the police, he ain't doing nothing.
Right.
He's
wearing New Balances. He's not. He don't have anything on him.
He not somebody who will probably be the drug mule in the hood.
No offense to New Balances. You know, I'm just saying.
Because New Balance starting to look
right.
Cool a little
say,
bit.
Yeah. Right, but now the.
But I feel what you said.
But what I'm saying is he don't look like the typical person that they would be looking for.
Yeah.
If they out here stereotyping.
Exactly. Not with somebody who connected with Diddy. Because why would Diddy be connected?
And the way that dude from Syracuse look, he could drive with tons of cocaine in the car and he won't get pulled over.
He won't get pulled over.
How you doing, officer?
Keep going.
Yeah.
They don't even go take his license or nothing.
He looked just
fast out here.
He looked like a small town. A young man that came up on the farm.
That's why, Diddy doing what he got to do. At some point, like, obviously Diddy is genius from a music standpoint and marketing. So all he did was use that genius and just some evil,
now Miami, crazy ways. Now, Miami hood.
Yeah, Miami, yeah. She really from the, like,
okay.
So, well, I don't know much
but she's
about
also been
story.
Telling us that, you know, she has sex for money and, you know, is willing to move drugs.
And she,
the whole time.
Whatever she got to do, get that bag.
Yeah.
She just really
from,
living.
Hold on, but she from the get that bag culture.
She helped start that culture.
Yeah, she did.
From the female perspective.
So, like I said, she put out all that information, like, do whatever you got to do to get that money.
Exactly.
And that's what she represents.
She was living
that lifestyle.
So can we be mad at her? Hey, listen, she rapping.
She was telling us the whole time.
You know what I'm saying? We get mad at rappers for lying.
So she a real rapper, huh?
That's what I'm saying. So she a real rapper?
Wow.
You know? But that makes sense, though, because her and her partner, City Girls JT, they had kind of, they ain't really been together that much. And everybody been like, why JT separating herself from Young Miami? I think we found a great reason why JT was trying to separate herself, because she know what's going on. Come on now, JT right there. She's seeing what Young Miami doing. She's just not trying to be involved in that. She's not trying to get caught into that. Because the moment, because right when I saw that news about Young Miami, JT the first person I thought of. They you can't even mention one without thinking of the other.
Mm.
So a lot of questions are starting to get answered, but it's like the more questions that get answered, the more questions we have.
All right. I was telling somebody, now that all this information is coming out about Hollywood.
Yeah.
Even the Nickelodeon kids coming out saying that they had got touched on.
Yeah.
Diddy, R. Kelly. I mean, are we still excited about these entertainers knowing that behind the scenes?
What's really going on?
Right.
I don't think we should be. I think people need to
We are heavily influenced by these celebrities.
Yeah.
And now we're starting to uncover the whole world.
The whole
instead of the videos, the upfront videos, the marketing.
Yes.
Now we get into the lawsuits, and it ain't sweet.
It's not. We need to stop idolizing celebrities. These are just humans with power,
right?
Who get that power and use it for
take
the bad.
That. Take that.
It for
take
advantage.
That.
They take it and they leverage it to just do crazy stuff.
Wow.
Like, we should not. And it's crazy because it's this girl on That's So Raven. Her name was Chelsea, the white girl who was Raven's best friend. She dropped a TikTok video after the Nickelodeon stuff and said, wait till her NDA expires.
What?
Oh, man. So now I'm scared. Disney is probably Nickelodeon was probably nothing.
Okay, but are they going to be rounded up? Are we going to see the helicopter outside these people's houses?
Oh, I don't know about that.
I'm just saying.
Not
at all. Oh, they don't do that to white people. They didn't do that to Harvey Weinstein.
They did that for Diddy, but not
Harvey Weinstein.
They didn't touch Dan.
Yeah, they didn't do nothing.
They didn't touch Dan.
Wow.
Even the dude who was doing that stuff to Drake from Drake and Josh on Nickelodeon, I mean, he spent, what, like 16 months in jail and got out.
Hey, look, Hugh Hefner went his whole life without being prosecuted. And now a lot of those girls are starting to tell the truth on the Lifetime channel. But they waited till he passed away and everything, and now all of this is coming out, and nothing ever happened to Hugh Hefner.
And we talk about the Diddy parties, the Playboy party, the
right.
Playboy Mansion parties.
They got the women talking about it right now.
Don't let no camera get, don't let no footage get released on that.
They saying Playboy. That he got a, you think Diddy got a catalog?
though. I know.
The Playboy Mansion had all of that going on. And you know what I started seeing? Like, some of the ways Diddy was acting and Vince McMahon was acting.
Man, Vince.
Some of the things they were saying that was going on in the Playboy Mansion with Hugh Hefner, they was trying to mimic it.
Dang. And that makes sense. And it's crazy because Vince was cool with all. Vince was cool with Diddy.
Right.
Vince was cool with Hugh.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, Vince was cool on with WWE Harvey. Back in the day.
What? He got Diddy on WWE singing, I'm coming home going crazy. Home right. Performance. What Diddy doing on WWE?
So they was, I believe that Hugh Hefner, the way he did Hollywood.
Man.
And had all the women and all of that. I believe they all saw that. Yeah. And they thought that they could duplicate that.
And they could not.
Now they making Diddy famous for freak offs.
Mm-hmm.
But it all came from Hugh Hefner.
And he was doing that for 50, 40, 50. Yeah,
this was his lifestyle.
Years. This is his life.
And they got a whole documentary on all the ex-Playboy women and people that was in their house, human trafficking, making out with animals, everything.
Man, I know it was crazy.
On the TV right now.
I actually want to see that. I seen some documentary, but it didn't go.
Oh, it was on Vice.
I got to watch that.
It's on Vice.
I got to watch that.
That's the channel it's on, right? Just last week.
I gotta watch because the only documentary I seen was he was in the
Surviving R. Kelly. That's what. That's the only one black people pay attention to.
I did see Surviving R. Kelly. I saw the first part. Then they start coming out with the part two, part. It's part five at this point. I saw the first part, I need to watch that.
How long you think Surviving Diddy gonna be? Like, how many episodes?
My goodness, they gonna need. There probably five different seasons with like 10 and 11 episodes in each season because all the stuff they potentially could unpack.
And what if he's just the fall guy? What if they raided his house to get rid of the evidence?
Where's the RICO? Right, that's what they said, but I'm glad where's the RICO?
Because Suge Knight posted something on Twitter and was like, now I know Suge Knight might not be credible, but hey, on this situation, he might. He said those people really breaking in Diddy house to destroy evidence from high people, from high powerful political people to go in there, destroy that to say, oh, we don't really got nothing. But they had it.
Just like they did Epstein.
Just like they
did Epstein. We ain't even seen the list.
Man, this has been going on.
Where the list? We ain't seen the list.
And it's still redacted, what they put out.
Right.
Come on, man. They just threw the girl who was with him.
And notice DJ Brother Z didn't put no rabbit hole music on that.
Because
he used
the truth.
Yeah. He didn't even put the rabbit hole on this. He ain't played that not one time. Because he believed it.
We don't have to play it. It's like, no conspiracy.
What? Hey.
Like, did Epstein kill himself? How did he die in jail randomly? He was about to go crazy and tell on all of these people. Now, Trump talk about he wasn't cool with Epstein. Now, man, get out of here.
Well, I think Trump had an incident where the police got called because Epstein, one of his friend's daughters, and then Trump banned him from all of his stuff because he was messing with one of his buddy's daughters.
That is, at least he got out. You know what I'm saying? Because it's the fact that Epstein, bro, so many high, powerful people. Like, it don't even matter.
The prince.
It could be the prince.
Prince Andrew.
Literally. And how come ain't nobody talk about Prince Andrew? Prince Harry hanging out with Diddy. Hey. Why is he getting brought? What is going on right now, man?
Hey, look.
I'm trying to figure
it's all
out.
Coming out. They say 2024 is the year everything going to come out.
Hey, 2024, year of completion.
I say even though it's coming out, are we going
to
change our behavior?
Wait, so
everybody getting exposed, but if you still acting the same way, you're going to send your kid to Hollywood.
Get stuck in the same cycle.
Right.
Man, they have to. We got to learn from this. We got to learn from this.
What's the message, Jason Smith?
The message is my main thing is to stop idolizing celebrities, stop idolizing entertainers, stop idolizing other human beings. They are just like you. All they do is got a little bit more money and a little bit more exposure. That is nothing. That's artificial. That is an illusion. You are good. Just be you.
It's all good until you get in that back room.
Because you go get there trying to idolize in these celebrities. Right. You go get to Hollywood.
Mesmerized by the marketing.
Man, you going to be walking around, seeing those rooms, peeking
trying to
rooms.
Send your kid to Nickelodeon.
Man, I ain't never working out no Nickelodeon. I was one of those kids.
It was a lot of kids growing up saying I wanted to be on Nickelodeon.
Man, I was trying to be on there.
On the Disney Channel.
I was trying to be on Sweet Life of Zach and Cody.
Hearing the casting calls on the radio.
Right.
Man, I was trying to go to one when
taking
I was
Taking your
kid.
Kids to these modeling agencies all that was it. Working, that was a funnel.
Yeah, and they taking advantage of these little kids, man. Mm. That's so scary. That's so scary.
That's so raving.
That's so, that's so raving. Eddie, Orlando Brown on there talking about the diddler. I'm just saying.
The school squash squash.
You know?
Whatever that was.
We calling.
Now he don't sound so crazy
exactly.
No more.
Exactly. We were calling him crazy. Have you ever been swallowed? Hey.
They said TD
Jakes was out there kicking
it
with
this. He on the list.
Come on now.
Oh, wow. Power bottom Jakes.
Oh,
come
wow.
on now.
Wow.
Are we including the church in this now, too?
We ain't going to go there. We going to have to say that.
That's what I'm saying. Because
that's a whole nother pop culture report.
That's a whole nother day, man.
Hey, look, when we come back, Truth Nation, we'll have more conversations. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. Truth Nation, we have a big announcement. The award-winning 101.7 The Truth is now the home of the Thanalysis Podcast. Tune in to the debut of the Thanalysis Podcast on Wednesday, April 3rd at 6 p.m. Hear Thanasis Antetokounmpo talk with guests like Buck star Damian Lillard, YouTube sensation Jake Paul, and so many more. The Truth plus Thanasis equals a championship duo. Milwaukee Black Talk.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
The award-winning 101.7 The Truth proudly celebrates Women's History Month. Listen to one of our incredible Truth teammates highlight the remarkable achievements of Black women throughout history.
Celebrate this year's Women's History Month, I'd like to take time to honor Judge Constance Baker Motley. When I think of Judge Motley, I think of one word, pioneer. She was a trailblazing American civil rights activist, lawyer, and jurist. Breaking barriers throughout her illustrious career, she played a pivotal role in the legal battles that reshaped the landscape of racial equality in the United States. Born on September 14, 1921 in New Haven, Connecticut, she faced racial discrimination but excelled academically. In 1943, she became the first Black woman to graduate from Columbia Law School, setting the stage for her groundbreaking legal career. Freshly out of law school, Motley worked as a law clerk for Thurgood Marshall within the NAACP's Legal Defense and Educational Fund. She quickly gained recognition for her skills in the courtroom, playing a crucial role in desegregation cases, including the landmark Brown v. Board of Education in 1954. Motley's brilliance continued to shine through as she broke new ground as the first Black woman elected to the New York State Senate in 1964. And a year later, she broke another barrier as President Lyndon B. Johnson appointed her as the first Black female federal judge in the country. Judge Motley's impact and legacy can still be felt today, even outside of the courtroom. She's inspired generations to continue to fight for justice and equality. Thank you, Judge Motley, for being a phenomenal woman and a pioneer.
Tune in to The Truth as we celebrate the greatness of Black women all month long. The celebration of women's history on The Truth is sponsored by the Milwaukee Police Department.
It's your boy, Tory Lowe from The Tory Lowe Show. Tap in for that action. Listen to The Truth all day, every day by downloading The Truth app or stream on Spotify, TuneIn, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, or Stitcher. Milwaukee Black Talk, 101.7 The Truth.
It's The Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Seven the Truth, Tory Lowe Show. DJ Brother Z on the 1 and 2's Pop Culture Report brought to you by social media sensation, Truth Nation, social media sensation, Jason Smith.
Yes, sir.
Whew, you got me sweating.
Hey, because now that was a powerful conversation.
Because it was a lot going on.
That was a powerful
conversation. We're trying to make it make sense.
Because we don't understand what's going on. Like, before the break, we don't understand why T.D. Jakes is hanging out. We don't understand why the prince is there. We don't understand why the royal family
is involved in this.
What in the world
is going on? Or are they not supposed to be involved
y'all
in
it? Y'all, that's not the U.K. Come on now. Why y'all in America over here causing havoc?
trying to find the adrenaline queen.
You're trying to go crazy.
Oh, the adrenochrome?
Adrenochrome, yeah. I don't know. Man, that's what they said, allegedly.
Don't get me started.
Where's Ellen again?
Oh, my goodness. Okay. Where is Ellen? Oh, my goodness.
See, and the thing is, on top of all of this, they saying there's UFOs out here.
Hey, I believe that.
I'm just saying. That, though. But what I'm saying is this is all coming out.
Yeah.
While the cargo ship hit the bridge in Baltimore.
Oh, my Lord. That, man. It's a lot of
stuff.
Oh,
wow.
So what's going on?
It's always something going on.
Why? What's happening?
Also, they saying that April 8th is the eclipse.
Oh, yeah.
And we need to get ready for it because it may be a shutdown.
I did see that it's going to be an eclipse. Yeah.
Like, and I was trying to read off the list. They were saying you may need to try to create a communication between you and your family. Like they were saying you got to get prepared. Like, are we even paying attention? Are we distracted?
No, we're not paying attention because, like I was just about to say, we distracted by all types of nonsense. Right. Look, because, like, this real, it's a real coincidence that all of this Diddy stuff and all of this stuff is starting to happen right now.
Mm-hmm.
They're distracting us from something, like always.
Right.
Like always.
And then they said it was a bridge in Iowa that caught fire right after the bridge in Baltimore.
So what's going on with bridges? It's not a coincidence.
It's the cargo that's coming through. It's gonna slow up all the cargo and the shipment and the goods.
That's slowing up a whole lot. Because I was listening to somebody and they were saying like a lot of the goods that we get here in Milwaukee come through Baltimore. Mm. A lot of this
right.
stuff. So that's literally directly affecting us. And that's affecting.
Is that a coincidence?
No, it ain't no. But I don't believe in coincidences. Listen, everything happened the way it's supposed to happen. Everything happened. Everything. It's a reason behind everything. Ain't nobody out here just doing all these coincidences. Mm. It's all just lining up right at this one certain time.
And why? How come everything that happened is on The Simpsons?
I just took a screenshot this morning and sent it to my friends. Bruh. And was like, this is getting scary. Because what did they have? They had the Baltimore.
Let's see the screenshot, Jason.
I got it right now. Hey, how do we put it on the thing?
Just hold up.
Hold it up to the camera right here.
All right, hold on. Let me get the
Y'all paying attention on 101.7 The Truth on YouTube.
Bro.
While we going live.
It said Simpsons are 50-0. They got the cargo ship.
What?
And then they got Diddy running from the cops.
No, they don't.
Come on, man.
Oh, wow.
Come on, man. Literally just said this morning.
And like I said, I think the Simpsons been telling us this whole time.
Bro, how do they know all of this? Because they predict
the writers.
Everything,
the propaganda,
though.
The writers, Hollywood.
Propaganda. I was just listening to Cat Williams. What's her name?
They stick it out there.
Bro, they saying like it's a whole in the Pentagon, it's a whole a division, a whole department dedicated to the film, and they are responsible for spreading the propaganda through film. Like Cat Williams
right.
like Hollywood is not here to entertain us. They are here to fill our minds with a whole bunch of propaganda.
Right. And that's why I say the mainstream media, they have their narratives that they stick out there. That's uniform, and then we get it, and we run with it.
Because we trust too much. We trust the government.
We trust the
too
mission
much.
Statement.
Why are we trusting?
Because
these
they write it up. So they write it up. The mission statement. We believe what's on paper.
See, they know what they're doing. This is all right. mind control. Like they playing with us. Like we just some type of toy. We some type of like we are the puppet, and they are the ventriloquists.
And like I said, even when it comes to political season, like they do it all year round. Propaganda through the movies,
just
through the news, through the mainstream media,
music,
all that stuff, through social media. If you're telling the truth, I've been shadow banned on Facebook for 2 years for helping my community.
That's wild.
But it's people out here putting fights, starting drama. They going viral.
It happened all the time.
That's what I'm saying.
This is crazy. And you know what's even crazier? You remember it was we did a pop culture report before all this Diddy stuff came out. I was sitting right there. And we were talking about whether or not Diddy has something to do with Biggie or Pac.
Right.
So after the Diddy stuff came out, probably a couple weeks later, I tried to go back and find the video on YouTube so I can cut it up for some reels. They took that off. They took that part off.
Right. Not only that, it's several of the shows that we had on that they deleted.
They deleted it.
DJ Brother Z went to look for it. What'd it say?
Yeah, it was
it wasn't there.
Blocked and yeah.
What is going on? Like I was saying this, we was talking about this before that all this stuff came out. So they had to go back because I know it was there because I literally sat and watched it.
Mm.
I go back the next week, it's gone. That like
They don't want the information out there.
So, because they are controlling this. They don't want the truth.
This segment of the Pop Culture Report might be deleted next week.
I'm going to have to hurry
you better
up.
You might have to strip it right now. You can't wait.
I can't even wait no more. I'm going to hurry up so I can cut some stuff up to post before they take this mug. They going to take it off Instagram. Oh, Lord.
Oh
my goodness. This is getting ridiculous. I don't know. I guess we got to start figuring out next steps.
You got my blood pressure going up.
I'm hot right now. I'm sweating. I got a sweater on. This conversation got me hot.
Mm. And so all those affirmations from T.D. Jakes, should I discard them?
Listen. T.D. Jakes, he's a great speaker. He's a charismatic speaker.
He got some teachings out there that everybody been using.
He's a Hollywood preacher.
Mm.
A Hollywood preacher. Hanging out with Diddy. Let's remember that. He's a Hollywood preacher hanging out with Diddy.
Is Joel Osteen a Hollywood preacher?
Joel Osteen not even a preacher. He's just an inspirational speaker.
That comes off as a preacher.
Yeah, that come off. He ain't no preacher.
Then when the homeless people need to take shelter, he don't let them in.
He's not opening up his church for people to come
in. But didn't his church just got shot up?
Something happened at the Joel Osteen church. Mm. But it was all the controversy. It was the hurricane. It was a storm. He wasn't letting people come in.
Right.
Bro, he ain't no preacher. He's a motivational speaker. He's an author. That's what he is. He ain't no preacher.
Creflo
no
Dollar.
Yeah, he ain't no pastor. Get out of here.
With a jet.
Come on, bro. Prosperity preaching. Oh, look at me. I got all of this. You can get it, too, if you listen to what I say. Get out of here. You just using these
people. You think they're going to let me borrow the jet to help the homeless?
He ain't letting you borrow that jet.
I'm just asking the question.
They only using them jets to go to Diddy parties. They ain't
worried
about
flying first class to Diddy.
First class to Diddy.
Damn.
Come on, now. That ain't worried about helping
nobody. All right, Jason Smith, I appreciate you for coming through for the Pop Culture Report.
For sure.
Hey, look, when we come back, we got company on the show today. We're going to talk to everybody. We got Doc B in the building, and we got Darren in the building. We're going to see him when we get back. We're going to listen to him when we get back. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
What's good, y'all? This is 101.7 The Truth's Telly Hughes, and I am Milwaukee. The goal of Truth Be Told with DT and Telly is to provide a platform for citizens of Milwaukee and Truth Nation to have their voices heard about concerns that have daily direct impact. So join the home of Milwaukee's realest conversations where you can speak your truth. We are the award-winning 101.7 The Truth, Milwaukee Black Talk.
The pulse of the Milwaukee Bucks, straight from a Bucks legend.
Can't get it off. Marcus Johnson will, though. Can't leave him alone for a 12th.
Tap into Hear District with Marcus Johnson on Bucks Plus. Marcus and his son Chris offer a weekly beat on Bucks basketball. Get your questions answered and hear from the biggest names in basketball. Find Hear District with Marcus Johnson at bucks.com/plus on the Bucks app or wherever you get your podcasts.
Donors choose. Support a classroom.
Build a future.
Did you know that every year, public school teachers spend nearly $500 of their own money for student supplies? Let's do the math. That comes out to over $1.2 billion a year. And that's just not right. At Donors Choose, we want students and teachers to have the tools they need for a great education. And now, more than ever, they need your help. Here's what you can do. Go to donorschoose.org and choose from teachers' requests that support reading, math, science, history, and more. Once a request is funded, we'll take care of shipping everything directly to the teacher. It's that easy. You'll receive thank you letters and photos from students and teachers and a report of how every dollar was spent. Teachers' needs have never been greater. Learn more at donorschoose.org.
Donors Choose. Support a classroom.
Build a future.
Being blind doesn't always look how others may think. Stargardt disease was supposed to define me.
Retinitis pigmentosa aimed to overwhelm my family.
It tried to cut me down.
A blinding eye disease attempted to force me away from doing what I was born to do.
But it cannot stop me. I have the tools.
I will keep moving forward.
Pushing past the limits of this disability.
I know where to find support and where I can be seen.
Loss of sight won't blind our vision. Innovative research, educational resources, supportive community. The Foundation Fighting Blindness is leading the charge in finding treatments and cures for blinding diseases. Learn more at fightingblindness.org. A public service message from the Foundation Fighting Blindness.
We are the home of Milwaukee Black Talk. 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha, and W269 DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
We need each other.
That's facts.
I need my sisters. I need my brothers out here.
A coward dies a thousand deaths, and for all the bootlickers, may you die 1,001.
The place for the realest conversations.
Tory Lowe, want all the action? Or you want all the smoke? Oh, this nigga, I'm with all that smoke too, man.
I didn't see Ron Johnson. He trash. Chisholm is trash. How the hell are you here to help us? And your kids are dying in the street.
I understand that this is Milwaukee and everyone believe that if someone says something, it's mentioned. It's not.
I don't care if it's the past. If you see the pastor acting right, you check that fool. Where's the results?
Talking topics that need to be highlighted and discussed in our communities.
Would you trade places with a black person?
No, I would not.
Have you ever said the N-word? Come on, be the truth. We on the truth.
Unfiltered and unfazed, this is the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth and The Truth app.
The reason I believe the racism is getting worse is because whites know that they will be outnumbered in about 20, 21 years. They're going to be outnumbered.
Hey, Tory, man, how are you doing, brother? I'm actually from India. We brown people can totally relate with you. And sometimes it's like, did that just happen to me?
We have to not let the government mind efforts either.
That cop ain't never been brought to the public because he ain't normal, and he may not even exist no more.
Say no more. Release the video.
You know, you keep on doing what you're doing, man. You're going to take over this talk radio, man. Just keep on focusing on what you're focusing on. I wish you a lot of love.
God bless you, brother.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio in Milwaukee, here is Tory Lowe.
The truth, the most requested advocate in the state. 101.7 FM. The movement continues. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Milwaukee, stand up. Yeah. It's Tory Lowe, the truth. From 1 to 4. We about that action, so tap in and let's go. We want that justice. We want all the smoke. From Monday through Friday, trying to bring the city hope. Yeah. Tory Lowe from 1 to 4, Monday through Friday, let's go. We bout that action from the block, and we ready, let's go. Tap in, and it ain't no holding back. We ready, we ready. 101.7 The Truth, Tory Lowe. Tory Lowe Show live from American Family Insurance Studio at The Avenue. The movement continues. The marathon continues right here on 101.7 The Truth. Thank you for joining me for the second hour of the Tory Lowe Show. And we got the legendary Doc B in the building, B-Boy Productions.
What's good, man?
How you doing, Doc B?
It's been a minute, but I'm glad to be here. I feel good.
And we got my co-host for the rest of the day, Darren, the son of DT from DT and Telly in the Morning, hanging out with your boy Tory Lowe. How you doing, Darren?
I'm good, brother. How you doing? What's going on, Tory?
Hey, you know I'm feeling powerful. Powerful. I appreciate you for tapping in today.
I appreciate you for having me.
Man.
Doc B.
It's all about Milwaukee. It's all about hip-hop.
Okay, so check this out. Milwaukee got 4 artists on the charts right now.
Really?
On the Billboard 100.
I didn't know that.
DJ Brother Z. Who are the 4 artists that's on the top Billboard 100 right now?
I know about two.
Big Frank, Certified Trapper, and JP.
And Huey V.
Oh, yeah, and I guess
you... I was going to say, that's three.
Okay. That's four.
I know. Before he said...
Oh, okay.
Oh, the dude is down with Rockefeller.
Yep.
Okay.
Hey, it's Milwaukee hitting the charts.
All right. I still want to know if they have a relationship with the DJs.
Well, you know, I guess getting on social media now, you can get...
I don't need you.
Right. Well, you know, a long time ago, the DJs wasn't letting these young folks in the city of Milwaukee. So let's not go there.
Gatekeepers.
These young people wasn't getting played like they were supposed to. But then TikTok started doing them reels, and now they got around that. You can't be mad at them. I can't. I can say now y'all can play it while it's on the charts. Hey, you can still get in on it. Hey.
Okay.
It ain't their fault now.
One or two and then done.
Because I'll say this. If you don't make a way, they going to find a way.
I like that.
Okay, so that's what I
see. I like almost like I need radio. Now I got to wait for you to play. Now I ain't got to wait for you no more because of YouTube, Spotify.
And I can go viral and I can do one of them little dances. You know, Milwaukee got like 8 dances out here.
I like that. I do like that too.
It's like we taking over break dancing.
Word.
Like, you know how New York had the break dancing?
Right.
Now it's Milwaukee turn and we got like 8 or 9 different dance
Starting
steps.
With the Stoli.
Going crazy out here on YouTube. So Milwaukee taking over the break dancing scene.
But I think
I'm
using the dancing to get in with the music.
Right. Because we dancing to the music.
Exactly. Right. So, like, we making them buy it with the dance, but we backdoor it really with the music. I feel like we using that kind of method to come into the game like we are right now.
And that's about content, too.
Exactly.
Like, and you know, social media is all about content. But you know what I'm worried about? What if they ban TikTok?
See,
what if that band go through? What if China don't want to up their slice?
Because you really ain't getting it out the mud. That's my push. That's my old school pushback. That's my Gen X.
Hold on, what you mean? Who's going around in the trunk? Who's going around selling CDs out the trunk?
Pirate ass videos, all that thing. Man, that's the part I don't. I like a balance. So I put it like this. How about this? Munch Lauren has a relationship with the DJs.
Well, okay, around, that's cool.
DJs got drops.
But y'all always let a few in. Y'all, I'm talking about for as many that's out here, y'all let one.
You can't
y'all only
all
let
in.
A couple. Okay, well, now they can.
You can't all get in.
Well, now they can.
No, okay.
They all on content. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying this new wave.
Right. I like this argument. I wasn't ready for your pushback.
I'm just saying this new wave.
We don't need you.
They got in the Rolling Stone. They made it to the Rolling Stone.
Some DJs pushing back because they don't have a good ear or they don't want to give a chance. Some of us are pushing back because your stuff is trash.
I believe that.
You don't have a clean version. You don't carry yourself right. You don't even call me by my name. Hey, DJ. And you sticking a phone in my face.
Right. And you're right.
So I'm finna put my job on
the line. And you're not paying me to play your song on top of that.
I only got 3 hours
But that same song you saying is trash is going viral on TikTok.
That don't make it
trash.
They went
and took it to
TikTok. Trash people like.
Okay, but what I'm saying is it about if the song is quality or if people like it?
It's about who listening to the radio.
Okay, I'm just asking.
That's a good point.
I'm just asking because I see a lot of stuff that I don't like, but everybody likes.
But I'm gonna keep it a buck, and I'm gonna say a lot of these people that's TikTok and making it through the TikTok, they not listening to the radio.
Right.
That's not their gateway to. You know what I'm saying?
Because
everybody in our generation, we think we a trendsetter. We think
we
the first person
influencer.
That did this.
You the feel influence what I'm saying? Generation.
Oh, yeah,
exactly.
Sure. Of course.
So I think that's the approach when if you're gonna be that DJ, if you're gonna you really select your tunes. Make it your style. You got to understand who is your audience,
right? Like and you got to target it.
Right.
So the DJ may not. I think it's gonna all come back. Have to come back around to the DJ, but I think the DJ have to mature with the crowd as well. And I think that many times,
I agree.
It's some things we just don't like, and it's not from our era.
Let me change from trash to it's. It doesn't fit in my mix. It doesn't fit in my flow.
Facts. It's just not for me.
So that's so.
I was
and I gotta take the chance. I gotta take a chance on my weekly job or my guest appearance because it's a million DJs out here now.
Right. Mm-hmm. It is. I mean, hold on. The Milwaukee hold on. Wait a minute. Milwaukee got a third of them.
I gotta speak
Milwaukee
to you
got
on
a third
one.
Of them.
Who ain't a DJ?
Hey.
For real.
And I got something to say to you, DT, son.
All right, look. Hold on. We're going to head to the lines. We're going to head to the lines. We got Milwaukee Black on the lines. How you doing, Milwaukee Black?
Hey, good, bro, man. What it do, man?
Blessings,
love,
brother.
Man, what it do?
A.K.A. Darren Jordan, A.K.A. Scratch Master D from back in the day. He changed. He rolled with the times.
That's what's up.
He switched switched cities. Man, you Georgia now, huh?
Yeah, for sure. I had the Scratch Master D for a while, but start making some noise. I got that little cease and desist from Def Jam about EPMD's DJ Scratch, so I had to make some changes.
Well, Milwaukee Black is our spotlight, our Doc B spotlight today.
That's my man.
How you doing?
Man, blessed, man. I can't even complain, man. Good to hear my OG Doc still doing it with you all, man. Y'all sound good, bro. Anything Milwaukee, I'm with it, man.
And I guess right now it's Milwaukee versus Minnesota somehow. I looked up.
Yeah, I got on
these young people that went out here and got into it with Minnesota.
Yeah, I thought it's us in Detroit
on TikTok.
Kids still.
Hey, but Milwaukee Black, how do you feel about the new scene, the new music scene where these artists are charting right now on Billboard? I've never seen these many Milwaukee artists chart on Billboard at the same time.
I just think it's a blessing, man. I think you got to roll with whatever technology is at that time. You know what I'm saying? Back in the day, I remember I came back from college, and the selling out the trunk was big, and that's why I produced Milwaukee Young Twan and Ice Moan. I did their main albums, it was just out the trunk. That was the hustle.
Right.
And Milwaukee dudes got down with it.
Yeah, Young Twan, hold on. I got to catch people. Internet. Hold on. Hey, Scratch, hold on. Excuse me, Milwaukee Black. Hold on a sec. Young Twan is also OG Tweezy. So, and you
know, yeah, I thought it was Front Row Tweezy.
Right. It's Front Row Tweezy, too.
It's Front Row Tweezy. My man, Front Row Tweezy.
Right, look,
the bus in Atlanta, game. Every time I turn on the bus game, I see him in the front row with a hat on. That's my man.
Hey.
I just want to clarify and keep the kids, and they're like, who is that? I'm going to let you know who they are still. Go ahead, my fault, boss. What do you think?
But I love what the youngins are doing, man. I mean, I love it. You know, I'm down here in Atlanta, so I still got a studio. And, you know, my son, he produces now, so he brings through a lot of young cats. And it's just a different time, man. The internet is such a blessing because I'm gonna tell you something. People don't know Milwaukee was one of the most talented cities for music ever. When I first left the mill, I went down to College, Alabama State. People were like, it's black people in Milwaukee. And me and my guy, Richie Rich, we became the main DJs down in the whole state. And they didn't know, like, Milwaukee has so many talented DJs and musicians and rappers and everything, but it was no internet at the time.
Right.
So I feel this is our payback. We didn't get to get our Nelly in or our, you know, Twist or whoever back in the day. So the more power to the build, the better, bro.
I agree. And that's why I say I always had a problem with a lot of the DJs when it came to breaking new artists. Milwaukee had a lot of DJs, and we should have been breaking a new artist every year.
I agree.
Like, at least some, at least, well, you know what I'm saying. Like,
or at least give them a chance.
You know, like how Atlanta, how they do in Atlanta. So I'm starting to see that TikTok became that vehicle.
Right.
Definitely. And it's funny you said that. Now, people ask me a lot, why you moved from the mill? Why? Exactly what you said is why I moved. And I think why Tony Neal and some other people had to move around, it was because at the time, it was rappers coming out. It was all sorts of people out.
Right.
You know, even my man Speech, you know, Speech or
right.
You know, Speech for Rest Development. But we just weren't getting the total support from the DJs. And when I was able to move down south, the difference was the radio. When you move down south, the difference was the strip club scene. So you could just, as long as you had money, you could work your club, you could work your song through the stripper. Right, because you work it through the dancers. My first little group I had by myself. I'm sorry, I did a lot of stuff before I got my own group. Before I had my own group, it came out the same time as Jeezy and Gucci. We were on tour with them and doing everything. And the whole BMF experience, I was right there at the club.
What?
And that was the scene back then. Yeah, you go to the club and you break the DJ off either $20 or a little something, something that goes in the air, floats around, or, you know, saying whatever, or else you get with some dancers and you just break them off a dub here, dub here. And just real quick to let you say, the funny thing watching BMF, I was in the club the first time they came back with Jeezy, with that song with Bun B and Jeezy, but homeboy DJ Funky, big DJ, he was not big then. He you know, he was just up and coming. He was a DJ that night. And BMF that night gave him $10,000. And they played that song at least 30 times in a row. You know the one that with Bun B. By the time the 10th time came, the whole club was going crazy. It's like $50,000 on the floor. Boy, we you know? I've never that, heard we call that, a day in my life.
We call that promotions.
Street team.
Hey, right, hey, Milwaukee Black, I got another question for you. When you said you was around that Atlanta area, was you at the Freaknik?
Yeah, that
you ain't on the documentary. You ain't down there. You ain't on the documentary that came out.
You gonna be? We gonna have any footage?
My kids keep asking me I'm on the documentary somewhere. No.
Oh, wow.
I went to two of them, though, man. Hey, man. Legendary, dog.
Oh, wow.
I wish every black man and woman could go to one. Legendary.
we have our main morning show host, DT. Her son is in here, and she's hoping that she's not on it. That's what she's hoping. She's hoping her footage didn't make it.
I got the little, you know, note of, through passage, like, if you see me, you didn't see me. But you know what? As a son, you appreciate that.
Real talk.
Because it was like, I wasn't thought of. I wasn't here.
Right.
I can't be mad at my mom.
She wasn't representing you yet.
Exactly.
She was living her life, her best life.
And I mean,
we didn't take pictures of our food and send it to people. That's it. We Gen X. We didn't do that.
I'd rather her give me that. Then I turn it on and I'm like, come on, dog.
Right.
Hey, listen. It's a lot of grandmamas twerking on that freaking.
Oh, wow.
It's a lot of church ladies now and deaconesses and deacons on there doing wild stuff.
Cardi and them in Star Day. Yeah, that's back with Yin Yang. We and Luke. We was already twerking back then. We was already twerking. 90s.
Hey, look. All right, well, we're going to run the break. When we come back, we'll have more discussion. We got Milwaukee Black. He's the Doc B Spotlight.
Hey, Milwaukee, 414, baby.
Hey, look, we in the building with Doc B, legendary Doc B, B-Boy Productions, and Darren, the son of DT from DT in the Morning, DT and Telly.
Really going down in the
news. Hey, look,
he knows Ernie.
When we come back, we'll have more discussions. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
Don't touch that dial. The Tory Lowe Show will be right back on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, join the Truth Team on Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and be a volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins will get a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That is truthcommunitycleanup.com to clean and beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
Ever feel stuck in a mental maze, endlessly spiraling? Sometimes an encouraging reminder helps. Be Sad, Keep Going is a mental health and wellness brand by Marina Miranda Creative. It reminds you it's okay to feel sad as long as you keep moving forward. By embracing your emotions, you're not just improving your health, but rewriting the narrative for generations to come. Join the movement today and claim 10% off their range of apparel using code KEEPGOING10. That's KEEPGOING10 when you visit MarinaMirandaCreative.com. Be Sad, Keep Going is dedicated to improving mental health by reminding you of your resilience.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Protect your dream home with American Family Insurance. And you can weather any storm. You'll also save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote. Find an agent at AmFam.com.
products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
The impact of a meal goes well beyond feeding our bodies. Because when people don't have to worry about where their next meal is coming from, they can truly thrive. Like Marta.
And now we'll hear from our class valedictorian, who with our hard work never ceases to amaze us. Please welcome Marta Moreno.
And Alex.
Hey, Alex, how did the interview go?
I did it! I got the job! I can't believe it!
I knew it. Let's meet up later to celebrate.
And Diego.
Mom! I got first place at the science fair with my volcano project.
That's amazing, sweetie. Congratulations.
Because when people are fed, futures are nourished, and everyone deserves to live a full life. Join the movement to end hunger at feedingamerica.org/act now. feedingamerica.org/act now. A public service announcement brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth App, and 1017thetruth.com.
Fire bitties to the flow right now. Eat her up, show her how you get down. Off the drink, yeah, she finna go round. Get up, hit the ground. Eat her up, eat her up, eat her up. Eat her up, eat her up, eat her up. Eat her up, eat her up, eat her up. Eat her up, eat her up, eat her up. Ooh, throwing plenty hunnids in the club, yeah. We don't give a f. Ooh, ooh. Baddie shots, they finna pull up. Yeah, we on the drink, yeah, we finna go up. And the party
look 101, serving the truth, Tory Lowe, Tory Lowe Show. DJ Brother Z on the ones and twos.
414.
Doc B in the building.
414.
Legendary DJ B-Boy Productions.
Man, the best that ever did it.
And we got my co-host for today, Darren, in the building. Hey, he the son of DT from DT and Telly, the morning show host. Hey, look, powerful.
Powerful.
Hey, look, we talking Milwaukee music. We got Milwaukee Black in the building.
A.K.A. Scratchmaster D.
Spotlight.
A.K.A. Darren Jordan. A.K.A. Milwaukee Lutheran High School. What up? Sorry.
What it do?
Tory, go ahead. I jumped on Tory. They're going to get mad.
No, go right ahead.
No.
You didn't do nothing. You this is your spotlight.
respect.
Hey, look. I'm going to tell you this. I love the Milwaukee veterans in the game because y'all been behind the scenes this whole time. And a lot of people don't know what have Milwaukee veterans contributed to as far as in the mainstream.
Word.
Milwaukee Black, what have you been doing behind the scenes that we may not know about that you had your hands in?
Well, I'm going to say this. As far as you are so right about Milwaukee, people don't know some of the powerful people. Let me move it back. I'm going to say this. A lot of people don't know from Milwaukee, Steve Haywood was one of the most powerful people in radio at one time, straight Milwaukee, along with Jerry Smoking B. He was the one, the whole Snap movement, the whole Gucci, all that.
They cut out.
Yeah, Jerry Smoking B was the program director for Hot 97. The whole thing you see BMF on that one tape. Who is this Smoking B guy? You see me say they're looking for Jerry B to get their record on the radio to get Blue Da Vinci. He was the architect of all that. So props to them as far as
Jerry
music.
Rupert. Now, hold on, it's Jerry Rupert on Facebook. So when they do the Milwaukee Atlanta. When they do those games and they go down there, we go down to Green Bay, you'll see him in the mix. Or when they do the Palace reunions up here, you'll see him in the mix because he was a DJ at the Palace, the old skating rink. But go ahead, boss.
That whole era was with Milwaukee DJs. Then you have, of course, Eric Bonet. He came up. When Mary Holly Berry, I'm not mad at bro. I've been in the studio with him back in the day.
We went to Tech together. Yep, we went to Tech together.
Yeah.
So.
My guy, Speech, who I started out with all the way, we started DJing all the way in high school at his father. People don't know what this is. You got to be OG for this. The Fox Trap, which turned to Hardee's, which is a bank now, but that used to be the arcade.
51st and
that
Capital.
Was the club.
51st and Capital.
Yeah. On Capital.
Cap Drive.
Yeah.
We getting a little history here.
For sure.
Yeah. And then I've been producing too. I got in, man. I was blessed. I got to work with Young Jock. Nas, George Clinton. I was A-Ball, MJG's DJ for a long time and their producer. Slim Thug, wow. Too Short, Bree, Yo Gotti, Big Yip, you know what I'm saying? A lot of people, okay. Lil Boosie, Jim okay. Jones. I got what? Blessed to, yeah, I only produced a lot of them, and it's way more. I don't want to be crazy on it, but I got to produce a lot, and a lot I actually got to studio engineer, so I'm actually the one recording now sometime. I'm the one recording 8-Ball MJG, and I learned so much from that to see how people from different areas, do they do punch-ins? Do they have their lines memorized? How do they do it? So it was a blessing. I rep Milwaukee the whole way, too, man.
All right. I'm going to ask you this question, and I want you to give me an honest answer. Is anybody ever walking into the studio without writing anything and just coming from off the top, creating songs, or is that a marketing strategy?
No. Great question. So back in the day, people were writing. When I was with a lot of people don't know Young Twan OG Tweezy. A lot of people don't know he had a record deal. He turned down because he's a good businessman. Back then, we were writing. A lot of people don't know. He had a record deal. They brought us down to Texas, the Swap House. He was supposed to be signed with all them when they bought MJG and all them. He actually turned the deal down, man, because he didn't feel enough bread. Back then, cats were writing. 5 years later, when I got my manager, probably 1999, 2000, my manager was managing Ball and G and Bun B, Trick Daddy, and Jazzy Faye. When I start engineering 8-Ball MJG on everything, they never wrote anything. Ball would sit up and be like, go ahead, Milwaukee, turn on that beat. The beat is playing. Okay, hit me. And I put on record. He'll record it halfway, and then he'll put something in the air, drink a little Hennessy, hit it again. And he'll start rapping at the end of the one and whatever. And so he'll do like three of those. That's a whole verse. I go back, clean it up, and that's it.
What? Okay.
MJG, yeah, MJG, same way. MJG would just start rapping, then he would give me another track, and just start coming halfway through. Nas was the first one truly I saw that tripped me out. He literally, we went in Nas. There, and he said, give me 5 minutes. And he was sitting there just sipping some whatever, Remy or whatever. He's like, I'm ready. And he just hit a whole verse. Not a piece of paper, not a phone, nothing. And the verse was hard.
Man. I want to play the Young Jock song you produce, and you see Darren Jordan on the credits.
Okay, so this is the Young Jock record that you got the credits on.
Yeah, I've been there, been there, done that. Yeah, man, she running back, so why not?
Hey, the other day.
All right.
Hey.
Hold on. Was he signed to Bad Boy at that time?
Yeah. That's just going down now. That's just going down now. That is just. Okay.
You didn't go to any of that Diddy. You ain't been to no Diddy party.
Diddy party. Oh, here we go.
I'm just asking. Hey. Right. He was in the studio.
All right, Frank Nick. Yeah, go ahead. Tell him.
Okay, so I'm gonna be PC about the Diddy project. Let me say this: Young Jock, still my friend, one of the coolest dudes. He had the one song going down, and I was the second producer. Nitty that did that was my homeboy. He was managed by my manager's best friend. They were friends, and Nitty did this going down. I was the second one in the studio, and I did that song with him. You know, and that went platinum. And so that was a good experience. As far now, I was signed not to Diddy. I was signed to Dallas Austin.
Okay,
so that's a whole right. other story.
That's Drumline, right? Dallas Austin did Drumline.
That's why you see me in the ATL movie. I produced like 2-3 songs on the ATL movie and different you know soundtracks because of Dallas. But Diddy did used to be in the studio all the time. I never saw the stuff, but I'm gonna say this about the game, man. And this is for the young people in Milwaukee, man. The game is what you make it. You got to make a choice if you want to be in entertainment, not just music, if it's acting, whatever. The game is what you make it. They're going to come at you in all different sideways, extortion, different kind of acts, drugs. You got to just stand on your principle of who you are. So I'm going to say this. I got invited when I first started my career to some of these parties, but I don't know if I can say this on radio, but like party tonight. And somebody threw me 2 8-balls. I was like, nah, that's not me, bro.
Right.
I never got invited to another party.
You were scared? You were scared?
You just got to say no. Say no, no to drugs.
I just never got it. I told them that wasn't my thing. That's not my line. You know, that natural green and, you know, a little hen. And I never got invited to the third floor or the second floor. I might go to a party on the first floor, but I was never invited to the second or the upper rooms.
Oh, wow. But did you see some of the activity of people that may have fallen into that underground? Did you know anybody that fell into it? And years later, they probably cleaned themselves up.
No, this is how it worked. Like I said, it's all a thing where people just kind of, you know, tempt you, man. Everybody gets to go to the first floor. You there? I've been at the first floor. Outkast there, L.A. Reid there, okay. Speech there, whoever. Mm. That's the first floor of the party. And he's at these mansions. Then it's floor 2 and floor 3. I never went to 2 and 3. I'm just going to be honest. I think floor 2 had women and different things, you know, at some of these, you know, industry parties. And floor 3, I don't know what happened on floor 3. I was never going to make it.
Oh, wow.
And I don't want to know. And I don't want to know, right? He's like, I don't want to know.
Look, I came from Mount Zion Baptist Church, 3rd and Garfield. Can't do it.
That's where our parents were. Yeah, we got the album. We got the album to prove it. Yeah.
Look, on that note, we're going to run the break. And when we come back, I want your advice, Milwaukee Black. I want your advice. What would you give for this new generation? And what do you want to say to the older generation, too, as well? Like, to how to deal with the new generation? And how can we continue to rise and get more artists on the Billboard charts?
Because I'm mad at the new school. They don't respect us. They don't respect the game.
Hey, look, when we come back, we got Doc B. We got Darren in the building. And we got Milwaukee Black as the Doc B spotlight today. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
I am Detective Tiffany, and I am more than an officer. I come from a family of those who have served our country, and I continue that family tradition when I joined the Air Force Reserve. During my time there, I was encouraged to apply as a police officer, something I had never thought about doing before, but decided to give it a chance. The chance I turned into a fulfilling career in law enforcement. I am more than an officer, and you can be too. Come join the Milwaukee Police Department by applying. Go online and search Milwaukee Police Department Careers.
We Energies want you to keep this important safety message in mind. Before you start digging, planting, or landscaping on your property, call 811 to have underground utilities marked. Calling 811 at least 3 business days before you plan to dig will help you know what's below and can prevent a hazardous situation. Our representatives will mark the underground utilities on your property for free. So remember, stay safe and call before you dig.
We Energies. People you can trust. Energy you can depend on.
We weren't sure adoption would happen for us, but when it did, it happened threefold.
Mary and her husband first met their 3 children when they became their foster parents. Little did they know that their house would become the siblings' forever home.
We had to help them adjust to the idea that they wouldn't have to leave. Children in foster care have lived and survived so much. We had to help them process their trauma. And now to hear our children say that they know they have a mother and father who take care of us, teach us, and love us means everything.
The Dave Thomas Foundation for Adoption is committed to finding safe, permanent homes for the longest waiting children in foster care.
I not only love these kids, I am just so proud of them.
You can help. Visit DaveThomasFoundation.org.
My name is Ariel. When I arrived in the U.S. at 19, I struggled to find job opportunities without my high school diploma. My entire life changed when I took a chance and got my high school diploma at age 22. Everything I have, my education, my career, my marriage, I owe to the Adult Literacy Center and my teachers. They were with me every step of the way, helping with my English and math, making sure I pushed through all the challenges.
Ariel
Your success proves that what I'm doing as a teacher has real meaning.
It was an honor helping you achieve your greatness. Now you're helping others achieve theirs. It inspires me.
Education was the key that unlocked all my opportunities.
When you graduate, they graduate. Find free and supportive adult education centers near you at finishyourdiploma.org. Brought to you by Dollar General Literacy Foundation and the Ad Council.
This Associated Bank Sports Update on 101.7 The Truth is powered by ESPN Milwaukee. I'm Alex Celez. Coming off their loss to the Lakers on Tuesday night, the Bucks are in New Orleans to take on Zion Williamson and the Pelicans this Thursday night. Tip-off is scheduled for 7 with coverage over on WTMJ beginning at 6:30. The Brewers' first regular season game has been postponed due to rain this Thursday afternoon as they are set to take on the New York Mets on Friday afternoon now. Freddie Peralta expected to take the mound for the Brewers versus Jose Quintana. First pitch is scheduled for 12:40 with coverage over on WTMJ beginning at 12:05. Finally, Marquette continues to prepare for their Sweet 16 matchup on Friday night versus NC State. Tip-off is scheduled for 6:09 with coverage over on 94.5 beginning at 5:30. This sports update brought to you by Associated Bank, proudly supporting your hometown team's member, FDIC.
This is the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Shake it to a bad. She shaking dummy. I just wanna grab it. Ooh, yeah. Another one like DJ Khaled.
I just hopped on the scene. Oh yeah. Me and my brothers got the green. Tryna get between them.
Young c**k didn't leave her home. Motherfucker, I got a brother for it. Bring her home.
I say DJ, can you put this song on blast? Put a in the back shaking.
I know and you know that she gon' shake that ass when I throw this cash. You ever told a I got G's?
No.
You ever make a bitty hit her knees?
No.
Well, guess what? I'm JP.
On my dime, make a
101.7 The Truth, Tory Lowe Show. Look, we got Doc B, the legendary B-Boy production CEO in the building.
Midwest mixer,
hey.
Rapper. I'm just B-Boy, man. B-Boy means person that's into hip-hop culture. B-Boys and B-Girls, which stood for Beat Boys and Beat Girls.
Hey.
So even I'm wearing a suit, don't matter. Whatever I'm wearing, construction outfit, don't matter. Briefcase, to the boardroom, to the streets, baby. B-Boy stands.
Puff!
What it do?
Hey.
What it do, baby?
And we got my co-host today, Darren.
You don't want to battle.
What's going on,
in the
y'all?
Building.
You don't want to with me.
What's really going on in the mill?
Hey, look. And we got the spotlight on Milwaukee Black, producer, engineer.
Friend.
Friend. Hey, look.
Milwaukee
native.
53rd Street School. You didn't go to 53rd Street School. You just live by there. Where'd you go to elementary?
Nah, I went there.
Oh, you went there?
I went to 53rd Wilburite. I went to Marshall High School for one day.
One day.
You couldn't have your name at school. What's up, boss?
How you get suspended on your day off?
No, I didn't get suspended. My mama took me up there, and 272 folks started fighting, and they rolled across her hood. And next day, I was at another school the next week.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
Oh, those are the gangs. If y'all don't know, 272419.
Oh, right. Yeah. Y'all may not know. Yeah, back in the day, Milwaukee is by the streets 06-18-19-272426.
One way.
It was a little different.
Yeah, it was a heavy gang community back then.
That's before the GD and BOS.
Well, it's a story that the Tupac came to Milwaukee and got ran out.
Oh, yeah.
That's true. My manager also managed the Outlaws after Tupac died.
Okay.
And when I told him I was from Milwaukee, they're like, man, y'all in Milwaukee are wow, man. He said, dog. He was like, y'all. He said, y'all had us running in Tampa Hotel. I was like, happened, man? And he said the whole thing in Chicago where they had shot the little boy. So he got on stage. It's all about thug life. It's not about no gangs no more. And he was kind of, Tupac was kind of like FGDF at VL, and all hell broke loose. And that my guys from the Outlaws told me they ran up on stage, pocketed him, drew down on stage. I don't know how people in the audience had pistols. He said It was just a mob chase. Him and Scarface.
Scarface, tell that story.
Spice One back to the hotel. They tore up the hotel down Milwaukee, downtown Milwaukee.
The Hyatt and Regency. Yep.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm not proud of that. I'm not proud of that at all. I'm not proud. I didn't go because I saw him at Jack the Rapper in the rave, and I was like, nah. Yeah, dude. Yeah, Pac didn't take nothing. Pac was he gonna say what he had to say?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Hey, even if it cost him his life.
Oh man, why you gotta go there? Why you gotta go there?
That's what happened.
That's real. That's real.
He stood. With, I only met him once. You know, was crazy. I met him, but again through my manager. That's why I was way younger. Down in Atlanta, that might have been one of the Freaknik years over MC Breeze's house when they did the "Gotta Get Yours, Gotta Get Mine."
Oh, that's right, MC Breeze.
Rest in peace, to Breeze.
Yeah, shout out. Rest in peace, man. Breeze was my guy down here.
Flint, Michigan.
Rest in peace, man.
For sure.
Yeah.
Now I wanted to ask you, Milwaukee Black, what advice do you have for this new generation when it comes to music and continuing to get on top of these charts? And what advice do you give to the old heads when it comes to dealing with this new group of artists that's out here?
It's trash.
That's a good question. I'm gonna say this for the older people, for all the OGs, the older people, you want to call them old heads, whatever. Man, don't be the old guy on the porch, man. Get off my lawn. Don't be the old angry guy, man. Mm. You know what I'm saying? It's just like
Doc
the NBA.
B.
Acknowledge me. Say, sir, can I dance on your grass? Can I make a viral video on your grass? That's what I'm saying. Why you putting your phone on the hood of my car?
Oh, wow.
Dancing in front of the bumper. Go ahead, my phone.
Hey, look, it's just like the NBA.
Go ahead, boss.
Doc, look, it's just like the NBA. Dr. J was that guy, but the truth is, it was no TV cameras. Then Bird and Magic came, it was a delay. They were those guys, but then when Jordan came, it was on TV, so he was bigger. Now LeBron got the internet and IG and all that. Mm-hmm. It's just, that's life. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Right. Dr. J, I looked at his net worth. Dr. J's net worth is $25 million. There's no way regular role players should have $200 million in an account, and the legendary Dr. J and Kareem got $25 million, but that's just how it goes. So the older people, man, just respect what they're doing, try to give them game, and to the younger people, respect your OGs. We can't be the only race, black people, who trick ourselves out of position, black people. In every other race, Chinese, Asian, Hispanic, the Italians, they respect OGs
right.
and everything. And
the knowledge.
Just that the knowledge. They want the knowledge because they know the knowledge is power. But black people, we trick ourselves out. And with the younger people, you just got to make one big decision. Anything is music. And all it is this. Which one are you? Are you quantity or quality? If you're quantity, put out as much stuff as possible. And it's cool. You can just say, I really don't care about rap. I just don't want to sell drugs or go to jail or anything. I just want to dance, have fun. Put out as much as you can. Quantity. If you want to be a Kendrick Lamar or something, a Nipsey Hussle, now you got to go talk to the OG. You got to get in better studios. You need a better mic. You got to make a quality product that will transfer all over just past a quick instant moment on TikTok. See, the TikTok is going to be quick, and you can make some quick bread.
Right.
Take that bread, buy some houses, flip houses, do whatever. If you want the long career, you got to start doing quantity. You in Milwaukee, you want to be the next Outkast, the next Nipsey Hussle, next whatever is in Milwaukee. The speech, triple platinum. You know what I'm saying? You want to be something where speech now is 54. I talked to him a couple weeks ago, maybe a couple months ago. He's still on tour, goes to Africa, goes to Dubai, goes to all those places, UK tours, and is able to make 2.5 a year. Mm. This stuff came out 30 years ago, bro. That's quality. You see what I'm saying? That's quality. No disrespect to the younger dude. Classic. But it's okay to do quantity, but it's do okay a lot of it. You need a new dance every week, my guy. You need to have a new, it's the hubbubub, it's the meal dance, it's the this. And keep doing it and save that money while it's your time. But get about chains and all that goofball stuff and make investments, and you'll be okay.
You only score if you shoot. That's our generation. We're going to keep shooting. We don't really trip on how many times we missed. We just going to keep shooting.
Hey.
I appreciate you, Milwaukee Black, for coming through, because that's history. You walk in history right now. Hip-hop been around 50 years. And I say Generation X, we've seen the beginning, the middle, and the end of some of our favorite entertainers. How it ended up.
Real talk.
Damn.
So it's just a blessing that we're here to talk about these things, because we got a new generation coming up. And like I said, it's our job to make sure that we do our part, each and every one of us.
I got a question for everybody. Even Brother Z, because Brother Z is in this scene too. All right, and Scratch, you as well. Sorry, let me call you Milwaukee Black. So our generation, Ghetto Boys, EPMD, Run DMC, Luke, we all sound different. We don't sound the same. This auto-tune and these fibers, this thing is all the same. Not all exactly the same, because I'm a professional, so I can tell the difference between T Grizzly and so and so and so and so. But it's still very similar.
Let me speak on that, Doc. Let me speak on that from a Sonics point of view. You are right. That was the great thing. Tupac sound like Pac. Guess what? Big sound like Big. Snoop sound like Snoop. Nelly sound like Nelly. Bone sound like Bone. Outkast sound like Outkast. Cuckoo Cow sound like Cuckoo Cow, which all Detroit sounds like now. Shout out to the meal. But I'm gonna say this, though. The reason what happened is because it started to be quantity. What was the quantity move? Before, it was very expensive when I came up to record a lot. That's why I got with Young Twan and Ice Moan. They had the bread, wink, wink, the long bread. We recorded at Battery Studio, $150 an hour, bro. Okay? Now, it's just a blessing. Cats can just get a crack version. Let me not sound already. They can get a version of FL Studio, you know what I'm saying, and Pro Tools, and go to work and do everything with some virtual instruments. The problem is everybody's sound sounds the same because they're all on FL Studio and then they're all on Pro Tools. Then what happens, since Lil Wayne, I call it the Lil Wayne effect, every rapper wants auto-tune. So what happens now is actually engineers who sell sound packs. They got the Lil Baby sound pack. They got the Roddy Ricch sound pack. So it's the actual settings on auto-tune. So if you do your inflections like somebody else, you sound just like them. But I kind of don't blame the kids, because this is what the record companies want. Back in the day, you were in the Hall of Shame if you sounded like EPMD or Rocky. If you were in the Hall of Shame, you sounded like Tupac. Now the record companies, they like, I want you to sound just like NBA YoungBoy. I want you to sound just like Lil Durk. I want you to go make a beat like him, do something, talk about the same thing, and we'll sign you. It's different.
All right. But yeah, you're right.
You're right.
That's the truth. Hey. We on the Truth Radio Station.
Hey, look, Milwaukee
sound like
Black,
the truth.
I appreciate you for coming through. Hey, look, Doc B, this was a hit.
Can he give his information? Do you want to get your information? Mm-hmm. I don't know. We used to wouldn't tell her.
How can people keep up with you, Milwaukee Black?
Or your son?
You really can. I really won't be on the socials, man. I'm still out here producing. I'm going to be honest with you. Laugh, though.
Gen X.
He want to stay low-key.
Your mama's mama's house.
Yeah, look. Milwaukee's so strong, because what you don't know is I ghostwrite hooks, too. And some of your favorite little rappers out here in Atlanta that you love, that was me on the hook. I can't do nothing because I signed a disclosure.
That's right.
Yeah, but I'm still doing it. I'm just, just on the low, man. And shout out. Thank you all for having me on here. Thanks, OG Doc B, and just everybody from Milwaukee, man. I always love the meal. Go Bucks, go Green Bay, and, hey, man, what it do, man?
Powerful. Hey, look, we appreciate you.
Love, baby.
And look, anytime you want to stop through, hey, when you come to the crib, stop through with Doc B.
Hey.
Love, I'll do it. Right. I'll meet you all in person. Let's do it.
That's what's up. All right. When we come back, we'll have more conversation, Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Dr. Ken Harris here, and I'm excited about the Truth Partnership with Versity.
There is a serious need for blood donations in the Black community, and Versity wants to bring awareness to this because it's their mission to improve patient outcomes, advance the field of personalized medicine, and strengthen the health of communities everywhere. This is why you should tune in every month when a representative from Versity joins the troop to share about what they're doing to make a difference in our community.
Associated Bank knows your small business isn't just a venture. It's your dream and a vital part of the community. And we're not just a bank. We're your neighbors. We're looking out for you. That's why Associated Bank offers quick online applications and approvals with funding in as fast as one business day, checking with no minimum balances or maintenance fees, and prompt customer service. Explore our products at associatedbank.com/business or visit a branch for more details. Subject to credit approval. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Adrian was seriously injured when a careless driver merged into her lane.
Gruber was there for everything that I needed. Any questions that I had, Gruber was there. They made me feel like everything about my situation and my accident was very important to them, and that made me feel good. And I would definitely call Gruber again for that.
Serving Wisconsin for over 35 years, Gruber Law Offices, one call, that's all.
They go above and beyond for their clients.
Skilled trade workers are the backbone of every community and also the Army National Guard. Soldiers trained to keep the power flowing, engines running, and in every other trade needed to accomplish the mission. These soldiers are on the fast track to learning skills that can set them up for success at home with companies looking to hire the best. Their resumes are being built through their paid training and part-time service. Find out how you too can learn a trade profession by visiting NationalGuard.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
I'm Shanola Hampton. Every day, millions of people face hunger. Today, I will share with you some of their experiences. I'm stuck between paying for medications or paying for food. John from Maine. After paying my bills, I can buy groceries. It's sad to say, food comes last. Alice from Oregon. I thought pantries were for less fortunate people, but anybody could be less fortunate in a day or even a second. Claire from Virginia. The Feeding America network of food banks helps provide over 6 billion meals to people in need each year. No one should have to worry where their next meal will come from. Together, we can end hunger. Learn more at feedingamerica.org.
You are listening to The Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Hey, y'all. Doc B's rocking on your radio.
One on one, seven the truth, Tory Lowe Show. In studio with Doc B, the legend, B-Boy Production CEO in the building.
Hey.
And we got my co-host, Darren.
DT 2.0.
Hey, DT's son, Darren, in the building. Matter of fact, we got DT on the lines. DT, how you doing, girl?
What's going on, King Tory?
Hey.
Thank you so much.
What's happening in?
Thank you. You got it. And King Doc B, it's good to see you. I'm actually at home in Dallas, and I'm watching y'all live.
Oh, love.
Doc B got the fly camouflage. I see you, baby.
So I'm ready for war. I'm ready for war.
Quick question.
What's up?
Yes. I love this topic, and I was hoping that Milwaukee Black was still going to be on. And I'm glad that Darren is witnessing all of this knowledge. So I want to ask both Doc B and Darren a question about today's incredible, amazing topic. So, Doc B, I'll be 48 in May. And so, as Tory Lowe was saying, we grew up where we witnessed the evolution of hip-hop as well as what is going on today. So when I was coming up, Tory, and co-sign if you agree, Run DMC, Salt-N-Pepa, Public Enemy, Beastie Boys, Sugar Hill Gang, as much as a number of those hip-hop legends had a political aspect of their artistry, hip-hop was fun. It was
right.
Fun. We would go to parties. And Tory, you, Doc B, you know, like, we would go to house parties We would go to clubs, and we would just have a good time.
Rarely a fight.
I feel
no deaths.
Barely a fight. I feel bad for Darren's generation. I want to ask Darren, too, from a socialization standpoint. Like, because now when you listen to a lot of the songs that are mainstream in hip-hop, it's just superficial. It talk about what designer clothes you wearing or who you're going to shoot up. And it's just, to me, it's not Doc B. It's not fun anymore. And I really detest that for the young generation, because if they knew when girls went to the parties, you know, by the time we got done, Doc B, you remember our hair was sweated out. All the girls that we walked in with, they was afros by the time we left. So I just want to get you and Darren take on how hip-hop is not fun anymore.
And how we danced with each other. And, I mean, you dance in a group of your girls sometimes, and guys might have a circle, a cypher circle, where they rapping over. But for the most part, now we try to dance with each other. And that's not a knock on heterosexual versus homosexuality. It's just that was how it went. You was there. You was trying to see the girl. Man, it's going to be some girls there, boss. And that's another reason why we didn't want to fight neither, because of that. But, yes, right. The general energy in the room was fun party. You know, it's party, not at each other. You got your NWAs,
right.
You got your Ghetto Boys, and you know they came in.
Then you had the TLC,
and then you had the TLC. Yeah, you had both. You had a balance. And Darren, I don't want to, you know, monopolize.
Yeah, no, I understand where y'all's perspective is from, and I respect yours, Doc B. I think the nucleus of our generation and the way it goes, especially because we don't have the credit of saying we evolved, you know, hip-hop, or we had a music genre that we just brought into the game. But right. The nucleus to a lot of our problems is the accessibility. And so the reason why we talk about the superficial designer clothes, or we talk about, oh, I'm about to shoot it up, it's the accessibility. We heard NBA Youngboy, we heard all these T-Grizz, we heard Rio the Young OG. Mm-hmm. He really had one. So I went and got one. You see what I'm saying? I may not have a father or somebody who really showed me, like, hey, I wouldn't have lived in this neighborhood or got a house in this neighborhood if I knew you needed a gun to walk down the street. Mm. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
And when you don't got that coaching, that guidance, it makes you think.
We back to the foundation.
Exactly.
The problem of everything. The nucleus. Is the nucleus. Exactly.
Look, we got to run the break. We going to hold DT over. We got the town on the lines as well. We got some talk to text. We got some people in the chat. We going to try to get to it all when we get back. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
101.7 The Truth and Associated Bank have teamed up for our Black-owned business give back. Each quarter, we'll be giving away $6,000 worth of free commercial advertising for 3 months to 5 Black businesses. To sign up for your business's chance to win $6,000 of commercial campaign marketing on the award-winning 101.7 The Truth, visit blackbusinessgiveback.com. That's blackbusinessgiveback.com. Let's rebuild our community's backbone through exposure on the truth. For official rules, head to blackbusinessgiveback.com. Associated Bank, member FDIC.
Research shows that high-quality teachers have the greatest impact on student success during the school day. By shaping their students, they are shaping the future. Yet while actors have Oscars, musicians have Grammys, and athletes have gold medals, exemplary educators who prepare every profession are just not recognized enough. The Milken Educator Awards set out to change that by surprising outstanding educators across the nation with $25,000 prizes and providing a platform to celebrate, elevate, and activate the profession.
Erica Steven!
The awards were created by Lowell Milken of the national nonprofit Milken Family Foundation. The journey to surprising the 3,000th Milken educator is in full swing. Who will be next?
Honey, they chose me.
Celebrate teachers, value teachers, thank teachers.
Truth Nation, we have a big announcement. The award-winning 101.7 The Truth is now the home of the Thanalysis Podcast. Tune in to the debut of the Thanalysis Podcast on Wednesday, April 3rd at 6 p.m. Hear Thanasis Antetokounmpo talk with guests like Buck star Damian Lillard, YouTube sensation Jake Paul, and so many more. The Truth plus Thanasis equals a championship duo. Milwaukee Black Talk.
All your favorite interviews and best moments live in one place.
You know, I'm working in the morning, and I was listening back on the Truth app.
Download the new 1017 The Truth app now. Milwaukee Black Talk. 1017 The Truth. Truth Nation, stand up and tap in. This is 1017 FM, 1510 AM WGKB Waukesha and W269DL Milwaukee, a locally owned Good Karma brand station.
We need each other.
That's facts.
I need my sisters. I need my brothers out here.
A coward dies a thousand deaths, and for all the bootlickers, may you die 1,001.
The place for the realest conversations.
Tory Lowe, all the action? Or you want all the smoke? Oh, just
me. I'm with all that smoke too, man.
I didn't see Ron Johnson. He trash. Chisholm is trash. How the hell are you here to help us? And your kids are dying in the street.
I understand that this is Milwaukee and everyone believes that if someone says something, it's mentioned. It's not.
I don't care if it's the pastor. If you see the pastor acting right, you check that fool. Where's the results?
Talking topics that need to be highlighted and discussed in our communities.
Would you trade places with a black person?
Honestly, I'm sure no, I would not.
Have you ever said the N-word?
I'm not.
Come on, be the truth. We on the truth.
Unfiltered and unfazed, this is the Tory Lowe Show on 1017 The Truth and The Truth app.
The reason I believe the racism is getting worse is because whites know that they will be outnumbered in about 20, 21 years. They're going to be outnumbered.
Hey, Tory, man. How are you doing, brother? I'm actually from India. We brown people can totally relate with you. And sometimes it's like, did that just happen to me?
We have to not let the government mind us either.
That cop ain't never been brought to the public because he ain't normal, and he may not even exist no more.
Say no more. Release the video.
You know, you keep on doing what you're doing, man. You're going to take over this talk radio, man. Just keep on focusing on what you're focusing on. I wish you a lot of love.
God bless you, brother.
Now, live from the American Family Insurance Studio in Milwaukee, here is Tory Lowe.
Justice Wisconsin, the truth. The most requested advocate in the state. 101.7 FM. The movement continues. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, Milwaukee, stand up, stand up. It's Tory Lowe, the truth, from one to four. We about that action, so tap in and let's go. We want that justice, we want all the smoke. From Monday through Friday, trying to bring the city hope. Yeah, Tory Lowe from one to four, Monday through Friday, let's go. We about that action from the block, and we ready, let's go. Tap in, and it ain't no holding back. We ready, we ready. 101.7 The Truth. Tory Lowe Show, live from American Family Insurance Studio at the Avenue. The movement continues. The marathon continues right here on 101.7 The Truth. Thank you for joining me for the third hour of the Tory Lowe Show. We got Doc B in the building.
What's good, man? It's good to be here, man.
And we got my co-host for the day, Darren, in
yes,
the building.
Sir, hey. I ain't going nowhere.
Hey, look, before we get back to DT, I want to get the town on the line. The town been waiting to chime in on the Milwaukee music scene. How you doing, town?
What's going on, y'all?
Hey, wow. I appreciate your patience. It was a lot
delay.
Going on.
That was a big delay. Okay. Go ahead, boss. What up, town?
I ain't tripping. I'm giving y'all time to talk, though. Hold on. Let me get it right, though. Doc B's in the building.
Oh, Doc B in his room? Doc B in his room.
Bro.
I love it. What's up,
hey, brother, grew up on that, though. And, you know, I'm going to give you your props, your flowers right now. You is a Middletown legend, for sure.
Appreciate
you know what
it.
I'm saying?
Appreciate it.
Love on that one. Hey, what I want to talk about is, though, that number one, 1.1, we the only place left for, to get the new talent. They went to the South. They already went to the West. It started in New York, you know. Now it's really, really our time, you know. Now, with that being said, you know it's going to be a lot of, you know, like Dr. B was alluding to, a lot of people coming out here trying to sign these people up, trying to give them in dirty deals or whatever like that. This is what I ask for the older generation. The older generation of rappers, the Dr. B's or what have you, you know what I'm saying? I let them young guys. You know what I'm saying? And then, you know, give them a little bit of advice about how not to get played, you know, so when it comes to these contracts or whatnot like that, or the inner workings of the music stuff, because y'all guys have valuable knowledge that the young kids for any other reason or whatever reason that's not relevant right now, but y'all got the knowledge that they can use.
So I appreciate
when they get
that.
They deal,
I'm with that.
Yeah, they can have the best possible deal possible. You know what I'm saying? Instead of coming in as like, okay, you're new guys, and we're gonna throw all this stuff on you that you can do. And you know what I'm saying? You gotta climb out of that crap just to make a dollar or make a profit or whatever not like that. You know what I'm saying?
And I'm gonna see you and raise the hand and say I'm gonna learn something from y'all because my social media game is kind of soft, and I can learn from, you know, I can learn how to go viral. I mean, I got good stuff, but who sees it? I'm like the tree in the forest. They don't hear me fall sometimes because they don't know what I do.
Man.
You know what I'm saying? They'd be like, oh, man, you here to pick up your grandson? I'd be like, no, I'm here to rock tonight. What's up, bro? You know what I'm saying?
Hey, that's a beautiful thing.
I'm still not. Oh,
that's a beautiful thing.
I'm trying to bring the village together. I'm trying.
Like
I'm Tory Lowe.
It seems like we got both the pieces.
Yes, sir.
You know what I'm saying? All we got to do is link it together. And you know what I'm saying? Well, I'm not going to be telling what I do because it ain't even the time or place for that, though. But it's a lot of talent out here. You know what I'm saying? And don't get mad at these kids making the songs for their genre because at the end of the day, the whole spotlight going to be on us. So you know what I'm saying? Don't get mad at JB. And I'm not saying you. I'm saying it's people that be hating or whatever like that, talking about the dancey dance songs or whatever like that. Let them do the dancey dance songs because when the people come and the A&Rs and the secret A&Rs, you know what I'm saying? When they come around there and they see that, and then it might be something else on the side. It might be the next big thing.
I'm all about the balance, man. So yeah, I'm with you, bro. I'm with you.
I appreciate you for tapping in, Town. Let's get DT back on the lines. DT, all the way in Dallas.
DT.
Ready to watch these Marquette Golden Eagles put it on.
Hey, let's go, Marquette.
We are Marquette.
Absolutely, we are. Really quick, Doc B, again, I'm glad that people, because for me, I'm a Tory Lowe fan, and I know that Tory Lowe is, of all the radio personalities, is one of the, if not the number one, show on the station. So much love to King Tory. I really appreciate Doc B you being on because we don't have these types of legends like yourself. And what I really appreciate, and I may be a little bit biased, but I appreciate the fact that you're embracing that handsome young man that I created sitting next to you.
Hey.
And listening and having an exchange of perspectives, because what we don't see enough of is the cross-generational dialogue. And I don't mean like back and forth on social media. What I'm witnessing here is two black men that come from two different generations that, to your point, Doc B, can learn from one another. So Tory, again, thank you so much for creating this type of exposure between a living legend, Doc B, what I hope will become another legend, my son, what y'all call him, DT 2.0? Don't tell him that.
2.0.
I want my own identity. But Darren, I'm so proud of you. You're doing wonderful. I love you. Keep it up. I'm going to get off of here and let you Kings continue doing what you're doing. But this is what the truth is all about. We got to keep having cross-generational dialogue, share perspectives, understand where we're coming from. So kudos to all y'all. I'm going to hang up, get ready for go Marquette.
What's up with Ernie? What's up with Ernie? What's up with Ernie? What's up with Ernie?
Ernie in the cut. He's chilling. He's asleep. I gave him a few snacks before I left.
All right.
You know, I got to set him up for success. I'll be back in a minute.
All right.
Doc B.
We need to know.
You know that's my granddaughter. So thank you for asking because you know I love me some Ernie.
For sure. Love.
All right.
DT.
Hey, look, love DT, that. Get back safe. We miss you. And be safe and have a great time. All right.
Love you back.
Okay.
I thought she went to the game. I thought she went back to the festivity. Hey, all right. I appreciate you for tapping in. Hey, look, if you want to chime into the conversation today, 833-212-1017. Talk to text 833-212-1017. Or you can hit us up on 1017 The Truth while we stream live in the chat. We got Doc B in the building, the legendary B-Boy production CEO, DJ, producer.
Hip-hop.
Doc B in the building.
414 representing, man.
And we got my co-host, Darren, DT 2.0.
2.0. Milwaukee, what you got to say, man? Tap in.
You got your button all the way up to the top. Man, get loose, man. You all right? You good?
No, I'm straight.
This is just, man.
When I leave the house, I'm on my squares. So okay, you feel what I'm saying? I'm always on my squares.
I come from the ribbon school. We be ribbon, so yeah. Don't get mad. I got you. And DT, by the way, man, girl, great job. Because when I met him, we met him, you know, in the control room, and everybody, we was respectful. He even gave me his chair because he had a chair there. He said, go ahead, man. You got it. You weren't even tripping.
Hey, hold on. We got a call. We got a caller on the lines. We got Curtis. Curtis has a question for Doc B. How you doing, Curtis?
I'm doing well, Tory Lowe. Thanks for having me on, brother.
Like Mayfield, baby. Go ahead, Curtis. What's good?
Hey, I called to give Doc B some flowers, man, because, you know, I'm around the same age as him. So I remember listening to MSOE as a kid.
WMSE.
Yo.
12 to 3.
You and Smoke and Pacheech.
Ooh.
You know.
Tony Smoke and Pacheech. Yeah, we was killing it.
Man, I'm telling you, bro. My cousin, my best friend introduced me to that radio station, man, and we used to listen to it every time it came on, bro. Man, and I grew to love you and hip hop through that station, man.
Thank you.
And anytime I get a chance, if I know you somewhere and I can go, you know, sit for a minute and listen to you on the ones and twos, I'm gonna do that. You a Milwaukee legend, brother. I thank you for sharing your gifts with Milwaukee and the world, man.
Salute.
There's not enough accolades for you as a hip hop legend in this world, man. And I just want to thank you, man. And that's all I wanted to say, man, because, you know, you made my days a lot brighter listening to some of your mixes, man. If I could go back and find some of them mixes from MSC, man, I'm telling you, dog, they were just off the chain, man. They just had us so hyped, man. And that's all I want to say. Thank you.
That's love, man, Curtis. All right, man, love, man. I hope I run into you out here.
I'm going to let you know when I see you, man, because I know you're still mixing up around town. So when I'll come up and introduce myself, bro. Thank you.
I'm going to get my information later on, too. So, you know, get in there and text me up, man, for real. I still answer my own phone. No secretary.
Great.
That's
great.
What's
thank
up.
You, man.
Hey, I appreciate you for tapping in, Curtis.
Respect, Curtis.
I guess we got to get around to this Diddy conversation.
Hey.
Since you in the game.
Hey, can I do a shout out to this concert I just saw of the New School?
Go right ahead.
All right, so I just saw this online. I saw the One World Music Festival with Chicken P, who used to be Lil Chicken.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. JP.
Okay.
414 Big Frank.
Okay.
OG Tweetsy gonna get a tribute. And OG T, you know, and rest in peace to Big Tech.
And where is this at?
This will be why you do that? You know what I mean?
I wanna say Miller.
It looked like let me see this. I mean, Riverside.
Riverside okay. Theater.
Riverside Theater. It'll be you're right, man. You're right. April 26th.
Hey.
So that's what's up.
Hey, that's
you need
that's
a, old. You need a DJ.
That's mixing old
between.
With the new.
You need a DJ to play in between. But hey. that's what I mean. And when I saw the JP, congratulations, I did say, does JP or Big Frank have a relationship with the DJs around town? I'll keep that same mentality. And I said it to the DJs, too. Do you know these cats?
Right.
Do you know these rappers? And what up, DJ? Man, the DJ got a name. What's up?
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? And the comedian got a name. And, the rapper, the artist got a name. So, yeah. You know, and, hey, you know, not to talk about our personal conversation.
Yeah.
Off the mic, I said, hey, your name is Darren. You got another name,
or like
you,
a stage name,
and not a stage name. And I say that because I want to give you your respect address you the way you want to be dressed.
For sure.
Because Just Bree, that's how Just Bree wants. She wants Just Bree. So I'm not gonna just call her Bree. What I'm saying?
No, I get that. And out of my mother,
that's some old school. That's old school. That's old school value.
She kind of got this platform for me right now, so I'm gonna just DT 2.0 it. But you know,
hey,
if I'm here for a minute, when
you come on this podcast, you can he'll have it ready.
Hey, real talk. 2 Chainz was T-Boy. I'm not gonna say he was T-Boy. Yeah, with a woman's breast. And Ludacris is like, dude, we can't market that. And he changed it to 2 Chainz. So his original, you know, people change their name. Scratchmaster D was Scratchmaster D, and like you said.
When I was down in Atlanta in 2009 for the Hip Hop Awards, me and 2 Chainz, he wasn't 2 Chainz back then, but we got into it a little bit.
For real?
Because I called him Duffel Bag Boy. Because I didn't know his name. He wasn't famous. He was just
real talk.
He was Duffel Bag Boy.
I respect right, that. Was song. He had a whole album.
Well, no, that was but the song was Duffel Bag Boy, so he didn't know what to call him.
Yeah, because I didn't know his name.
Because
yeah.
It was just, what was the name of that group?
Player Circle.
Player Circle. So
I knew it was Player Circles and Lil Wayne.
Right.
And then when I saw him when we was down in Atlanta for the 2009 right. Hip Hop Awards, I called him Duffel Bag Boy.
Right.
And we was in the elevator, and he was like, his name was T-Boy at that time.
Right, real
but
talk.
It might have been the boy, Tory Lowe.
But that's what the name of the song was.
Yeah.
And nobody knew who he was. He wasn't the 2 Chainz we knew right now.
We only knew Wayne. We only know who Wayne was.
We knew who Wayne was. You still can't name the third member of Player Circle.
There was 3 of them, or 3 of them?
Well, 2.
It was 2. Player Circle was 2, and Lil Wayne was featured on the song.
Right. Right, so yeah,
I thought it was Lil Wayne, so.
But whether it's right, like my man said, like Scratch was saying, whatever Milwaukee Black was saying, whatever your name is, I always do that with people. Now, if I can't pronounce your name, then okay, then we can figure out something else. But you have a right to be. Everybody has a right to be called who they are,
right?
And that's the moral of the story.
That's what I'm talking about. That's hey, look, when we come back, I want to get your
perspective
on what's going on with Diddy.
I was about to say he had a lot of names.
And in love.
How many names love, did Diddy go through? Puffy. Since we're talking about names.
Well, every time how he needed to refresh, he had to refresh. Hey, look, when we come back, we'll have more conversation. We got Doc B in the building, and we got my co-host for today, Darren,
DT 2.0
in the building. Look, when we come back, we'll have more conversation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
Don't touch that dial. The Tory Lowe Show will be right back on 101.7 The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
One smile is great, but one smile in a community of smiles is so much better. A smile has a secret power that most people don't know about. A smile multiplies. It spreads from one person to the next, stretching across entire groups of people. Smile Train knows this and is proud to be creating a wave of smiles across the cleft lip and palate community in over 70 countries. Patients, doctors, advocates, fundraisers. Collectively, our smiles are a celebration of the transformed lives of over 1.5 million children. Learn how Smile Train is helping the cleft lip and palate community at smiletrain.org/learn. Smile Train, changing the world one smile at a time.
Truth Nation, we have a big announcement. The award-winning 101.7 The Truth is now the home of the Thanalysis Podcast. Tune in to the debut of the Thanalysis Podcast on Wednesday, April 3rd at 6 p.m. Hear Thanasis Antetokounmpo talk with guests like Buck star Damian Lillard, YouTube sensation Jake Paul, and so many more. The Truth plus Thanasis equals a championship duo. Milwaukee Black Talk.
Life's better with American Family Insurance because our home policies help protect your dreams and come with peace of mind. Save up to 25% by bundling home, auto, and life. American Family Insurance. Get a quote, find an agent at amfam.com.
Products not available in every state. Discounts may not apply to all coverages on an auto or home policy. Discounts do not apply to life insurance policies. Visit AmFam.com to learn how discounts may apply to you. American Family Mutual Insurance Company, S.I. and its operating companies, American Family Life Insurance Company, 6000 American Parkway, Madison, Wisconsin.
Saving energy and money is easier than you think. Here are 2 simple things you can do to reduce your energy use and lower your energy bill. Use thermal curtains to reduce each room's energy loss by up to 25%, and make sure vents aren't blocked by furniture or rugs to improve airflow and comfort. Simple, smart savings. Get more energy saving tips at weenergies.com. When it comes to getting the smile of your dreams, you can't just trust anyone. So look no further than Bubon Orthodontics. Bubon Orthodontics is Wisconsin's number one Invisalign provider and has been providing the best value for braces and Invisalign since 1993. With 15 convenient locations, you're sure to find one in your area. Schedule your free consultation today. Call or text 262-522-7447 or visit BubonOrtho.com. Bubon Orthodontics, a family treating families.
Teachers are dynamic leaders.
shaping a new generation. They bring a variety of perspectives from diverse backgrounds, innovating how they teach to prepare students for our fast-changing world. Achieving this takes skill and expertise. They're tireless explorers, creatively discovering a universe of solutions, telling stories, experimenting, inspiring, mentoring, connecting cultures, and connecting with each other. Leading by example. Experience the unique joy of helping students thrive. Teaching is a journey that shapes lives. Are you ready to begin? Explore teaching at teach.org, a campaign supported by the U.S. Department of Education, teach.org, and 1 million teachers of color.
This is the Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth, The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
This can only be the work of Dr. B.
Brewer season is finally here, and we want to celebrate the Milwaukee Brewers with you, Truth Nation. From now through the end of April, we will be giving away tickets to cheer on the Brewers live from American Family Field. For your chance to win a pair of tickets to the game, you must download the 101 Truth app and be on the lookout for our weekly Brewers push notification. Play ball with the truth and go to Brew Crew by downloading 101.7 The Truth and looking for those Brewers push notifications. Also, the award-winning 101.7 The Truth proudly celebrates Women's History Month. Tune in all March as we celebrate the remarkable achievements of women throughout our history. Follow The Truth on Facebook and Instagram as our very own Carrie Noni will interview history makers and share inspiring stories of the excellence of our Black women. 101.7 The Truth celebration of Women's History Month is sponsored by the Milwaukee Police Department and Truth Nation. Join the Truth team Saturday, April 13th for our third annual Tory Lowe Community Cleanup. We want you to go to truthcommunitycleanup.com to sign up and volunteer to help keep Milwaukee clean. Everyone who joins gets a free lunch provided by Cousin Subs. Register today at truthcommunitycleanup.com. That's truthcommunitycleanup.com to help beautify our city together. The Truth Community Cleanup is sponsored by Cousin Subs and Safe and Sound.
Man, I'll never be here when Subs come through, man. Ooh. Hey. That be sound delicious.
Pow.
Let me see, but like, which one you want? You're like, I already got a...
Pow.
Man, that'd be hilarious, though.
Hey.
Be like, brother, see which one you want? You're like, I just had to...
Right.
I was like, all right. He is not waiting.
Pow. That's all powerful. I can say.
Powerful. That's my favorite. Hey. Steak and cheese, though.
Now,
man, like lettuce.
This is maybe, you know.
Better bread.
I don't know how deep your roots go in the industry, but you got some deep roots.
Word. I do. I always say I'm a square because I really don't smoke or drink. I like Coke, Sprite, Pepsi, lemonade, water.
So you only been on level one?
I only been on.
You ain't go to level two or three?
I don't want to tell.
Okay. Oh, wow.
You know, I'm a Sagittarius, man. That's half man, half horse.
I was going to say, hey, I was definitely with you at Summerfest last year.
All right.
Come on now.
What is your opinion about Diddy?
Scorpio and Sagittarius, man. That's usually some sexual energy in there.
Oh, wow.
We the mind and the body. I'll just put it like that.
What is your opinion about what's going on with Diddy right now?
That's one of those, I hate this saying, but it's one of those, what's done in the dark comes to the light. And mm-hmm. and what this is one I would say to my B-Boy Productions staff when we be talking. What's up, boss? My fault, waving at the people through the window. I'm sorry. But I always say, what you do is your resume. How you act and how you behave is your resume. And they never, they come up to me now and tell me like, man, I know what you're talking about now. Meaning, so what you doing, how you treat people when the cameras aren't on, when nobody's going to catch you. So when your mom's give you that money and it didn't cost as much as she thought and you don't bring that change back or your friend working,
right.
You got a discount and you don't even come back and offer to let her say, keep the change, Those little things add up on your integrity. And so I don't know what's up, but I do say, I do know this from friends in the industry. They are submitted beats to do, and somehow those beats end up coming out and they don't get the
credit.
The credit. That's how I've heard about him a few times, and it's very legitimate people who have told me that.
Doc B, is it fair to say that the chickens are coming home to roost?
I'm nervous about that just because how people treat us overall and how hard it is to get, but if it kind of feels that way.
Okay.
It kind of feels that way, you know what I'm saying? But overall, I just want to see, I like to see a balance. I want to see people get justice if they're our victims.
Right.
So if they are victims, and then I want to see there to be some compassion. So, like, I was one of the only ones, you know, I get a little verbose. I was one of the only ones who said when Bill Cosby kind of went down at first, after a while, y'all not even going to check up on Bill Cosby? Y'all don't even care? Like, all the legendary stuff, all the HBCUs and all the donations and all the people that he inspired us from Fat Albert to A Different World,
right?
Mm-hmm. To seeing a lawyer and a doctor on TV, mm-hmm. the way he changed the game, he tried to buy NBC. We gonna throw that. I'm not saying don't punish him. I am saying he is a legend. He's one of ours. Mm. That's my son. That's my whoever. That's my dad. That's my friend. You know what? Let him pay his debt to society. But you ain't gonna do this. And I'm saying we don't do that. We get into,
we just throw him in the trash.
My friend would say, when you walk into a room and everybody's stepping on somebody, stomping on them, instead of you going, hey, what are y'all doing? You just start stepping on them too because you don't want to be that person on the ground.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's, I'm careful not to do that too quickly before I get more information.
Does
that make sense?
Do you feel that way about all the celebrities when these things happen, like R. Kelly? You know, because they make it seem like we the face of this stuff, but we really not.
Right.
We really mimicking people from other different races they've observed, and then they try to think that they can do the same thing and get away with it.
For sure. I mean, hey, you didn't. Yeah. With Kel's the same thing. Although I do still play his music.
Right.
But you know, so, and I think there's a little bit of who's the one? What's the one with the? You say you didn't. The girl. He had the thing. You sound.
Aaliyah?
No. It was like the one track. You better be careful what you say to me. She put her daughter.
I forgot her name.
Her niece is the
Sparkle?
One. Sparkle. So she was talking crazy on the what you call it, right? So. Her niece is the one that allegedly got urinated on.
Right.
So she talking crazy, talking slick, talking whatever, and then saying she did it on her own. But, like, if you know this about this dude, you just got through saying the wife, you know, the wife is up being held hostage. She got to ask permission to come out and use the bathroom.
Right.
So why is you even letting your niece?
Why you leave the niece over there?
Why is your niece over there? Oh, but she came back without my knowledge. I'm like, yeah, but why are you
sending them over there to Flavor Camp?
My man. I'm just saying.
Hey.
I'm just saying. Jeffrey Dahmer got a babysitting or a cookbook. You ain't finna follow it.
Especially if you know what's the secret recipe. Hey, look, we got some callers on the line. We got Eddie on the lines. Eddie, you on the new 101.7 The Truth. Tap in.
I know that ain't who I think it is.
Good day, everybody. Happy Friday to you. How are you?
Friday.
Friday's Thursday.
It's Thursday, boss.
Today's Friday.
White privilege.
It's Thursday.
Hold on. He might have white privilege. Hold on. Let's check his white privilege.
Hey, look.
It's going to be
Thursday. I think Eddie been painting. You've been out there painting and smelling the fumes, Eddie.
Yeah, sniffing the fumes, right? Yeah. We get an extra day. It's part of our privilege package.
Hey.
Oh, good Friday coming.
What's going on, Eddie?
First of all, I'm going to ask two questions. Let's not get wrapped up in the first question, but... what are your folks doing? What are you folks doing about, I know, the folks at The Truth at 101.7 believe in diversity.
Did you read the pamphlet? What's going on?
No, I've been on the show for going on 3 years, Tory.
By the fact that we let you on, that's the diversity.
Well, you have to.
People
have
from
to.
All different you, cultures
the show's
and
happen,
backgrounds
Tory.
Call in, Eddie.
I understand, but I am the Caucasian caller. Let's be honest.
Here we go.
Okay, now, Tory.
You're up there. You're in the top. You're in the top five.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, the top. So the thing about this is, what are you folks doing to reach out to young Caucasian males who want to have a career in rap? Maybe somebody who's talented, and you see the talent in this young Caucasian, and you might want to reach out to him and help develop him. Is there any of that going on?
Yeah, of course. If you were looking at TikTok, there's even a white girl rapper in the mix with Big Frank. And they promote another white rapper. If you're on TikTok and you're seeing what's going on with JP and Big Frank, you see whites in the mix doing songs all the time. Hispanics, all of that.
I look at it
and
like.
And then there's this.
Oh, okay. Can I answer that, please? I look at it like most of the other cultural things that we create, and hip hop is something we definitely created from nothing. We tap into light poles to get electricity to do block parties. We take two records that don't have any instrumental and play the instrumental part before the vocal to create a rap instrumental beat. And then what happens is, with most things like jazz and everything else, Caucasians and others snatch our stuff up and own it. So it's on you guys to knock on our doors. We let you in, Eminem.
And plus, you got Island Boys. Wasn't that your group? Wasn't you a big fan of the Island Boys? Island Boys.
That's funny. Beastie Boys is one of my favorite groups. Me and Sherwin used to argue over that.
No, but Eddie is a fan of the Island Boys.
The Beastie Boys are horrible?
No. The Island Boys are Tory. You're saying I'm a fan of the Island Boys.
What?
I'm not a fan of the Island Boys.
Hey,
you got.
Tory. I don't know much about the rapping music. Okay. So I do have something else to say, Tory.
Go right ahead.
And it isn't about rapping.
Hurry up.
You know this whole P. Diddy thing. Okay. It just seems like. Everybody was a part of this. Mm-hmm. And then I think it's, like I said, buyer's remorse. And they might have felt bad, after the fact that they were a part of this. They were embarrassed or humiliated or felt used or whatever it may be. But they were a part of it. They were a party to the crime, to this stuff. And I can't believe some of this stuff took 25 years to come out, and they're all victims now. But they were still going to the parties, still benefiting from his finance. Still rubbing elbows with all his friends. I mean, it's obvious what's going on. This is a witch hunt is what it is.
Mm. And it's bigger than Diddy. It goes up higher.
Every man and woman for himself at that point.
Well, trying to see, does it go all the way up to the real executives that is behind it too as well? I'm just waiting for those names to come out. But like Epstein, they never released all the names in the book.
Oof.
We still ain't seen all of these people who's a part of this circle. They just try to stop it at one person. But if it's worth $1 billion and these people are worth billions of dollars, where are all the people?
They might be working on some other ones and they want them to flip. And they waiting for them to flip.
Black Conscious.
They waiting for the flip.
You're on the new 101.7 The Truth. Tap in.
Eddie's gone.
Oh. Yo, so I got to make this real quick because I know y'all doing another segment. Eddie, I answer your question. What we do with European young rappers? That one, we send them to P. Diddy to audition. Second of all,
Justin Bieber.
Hey, Justin Bieber started off, and he's like, no, I don't want to go back.
Black Conscious, what's your other name? Listen. What's that other name, Black Conscious? Don't you got another name too?
Najoya.
I like that. Respect, boss. Go ahead.
So listen here, real quick. Epstein is not dead. He had enough influences and power that they gave him that little pill that makes you dead, and he off, and because that's why the list didn't come out, because there's too many people in there that would have went down. That's why they couldn't put the list out. Yeah. Have you noticed they ain't had no funeral for him? There was no funeral service for him. No one.
That's so suspicious.
Out of here.
It wasn't a funeral.
It's suspect.
No, he was just dead, and that was it. That's because he had one of them little CIA pills that can make you seem dead for a few minutes. They take you off. That's real life. And then they bring you back to life, but you can't never bring your face. You got your little money over Switzerland, so you got your little secret banking account. So that's that. Now,
wow.
The brother said it earlier. We need to stop holding these celebrities to almost godlike standards. because they are human and they do, they have stuff that they do that they've been doing, but it's only been kept because of the money and influence that they have. But when these come out, don't be surprised. They're human. They put on their pants just like we do. And they have desires just like some of us do. They just got a little bit more means of getting an extra desire of their choice, and then it feeds it to a problem. Live righteous, Milwaukee. Love, brothers.
Respect.
I'm out.
Respect, boss.
Hey, look. Well, I appreciate you, Doc B, for coming through.
Love, man.
Pow!
Thank you, Doc B.
Thank you for having me.
Hey, look.
Once a month.
And my co-host.
Like Milwaukee, man. Yes, Milwaukee sir. Music.
Darren in the building.
DT 2.0.
Big ups to Big Jam, Ben Jammin', because I'm inspired by the Ben Jammin' Milwaukee Spotlight. So
that's what I'm talking about.
I bring some old school in, old school, new school.
Hey, look.
And I even got an Ice Moan new record, but I don't know. Maybe we could play that on the way, you know?
Hey,
Ice
look.
Moan and the Ying
load
Yang
Twins. Load that Ice Moan up, DJ.
And Kane from the Ying Yang Twins. They got a new one.
Hey, Doc B, I'm gonna give you the last words before we run the break, and I appreciate you for coming through. Hey, look, I'm waiting on the next Doc B Spotlight.
Respect. Thank you. No doubt. Big ups to my mentor, Grandmaster Flash, nationally and locally, Ernie G, and all other old school giants. I stand on the shoulders of giants. I think I'm number one right now. I don't think nobody can touch
you
me.
You feeling like Muhammad race. Ali?
I feel like I'm the greatest to ever do it, but I didn't do it on my own. I didn't get here by myself like Obama said. Get at Doc B 24/7, DocBMKE.com. That's the website, and then my number's right there. No secretary, straight to me. Mm-hmm. I got Ice Moan, the new one, King of the Clubs, even though that's new DJ New Style's moniker too. But him and Kane from the Ying Yang Twins.
Okay.
Clean version.
That's a new song?
It's a new song.
Let's check it out.
What you got? Brother Z.
Oh, we
got
to do it after break. We late.
Okay. Oh, we got to do it after break?
I'm going to take the headphones off.
Truth Nation, we'll be back with more conversations. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
Nice.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 101.7 The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com. This is your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute.
Social injustices have created a long-standing list of disparities in education access and the quality of education. Injustice is also seen in sexuality education provided to students. Students really need the full spectrum of what it means to have the information so that they can take care of themselves. Reproductive justice leaders advocate for schools to provide comprehensive sexuality education, which helps students to prevent unintended pregnancies and obviously increase their chances of graduating. It's really important for the listeners to remember that even if you don't have students in MPS, even if you're not a parent, those students are part of our community and they deserve our support. The more that they receive, the better off they are, the better off our community is.
This has been your Planned Parenthood Advocates of Wisconsin Minute on the new 101.7 The Truth.
Increase in taxes while families are paying more for everything from gas to groceries is wrong. Milwaukee voters should oppose increase in property taxes by nearly 30% in order to provide increased funding yet again to Milwaukee public schools. They've already wasted nearly $1 billion in new taxpayer funding, and now they want more? They don't even have a plan on how they'll spend it. Enough is enough. Milwaukee voters should just say no.
Paid for by Enough is Enough. Vote no.
At UW Credit Union, our home loans have everything you need for your next big step, including up to $750 off closing costs for all home buyers. And first-time buyers can save even more. So if you're ready to trade roomies for more room or your town home for an out-of-town home, UW Credit Union will be with you from start to furnished. UW Credit Union. Apply online today. Equal housing lender. Credit may be limited as required by program. Visit uwcu.org for details.
From my family and myself, I would like to say thank you to Gruber Law Offices for taking such good care of us.
I would say thank you because you're so human and so much of a friend during the whole process.
I'm super grateful for them representing me and doing all that they did for me.
I would just say thank you for making me feel better.
That's why I'm here, to say thank you, thank you, thank you.
Gruber Law Offices, one call, that's all.
My part-time service in the Army National Guard makes it possible for me to be more for the community I call home. My training helps me at work when I lead by example. My service in the Army National Guard allows me to keep my community and those I care about safe from threats. Learn more about how you, too, can live and serve part-time close to home by visiting NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
This is the Bloomberg Black Business Beat. The banking industry is working hard to try to earn the trust of black households. Research from the McKinsey Institute for Black Economic Mobility shows that avoiding banks is costing black families money and could be a key contributor to the racial wealth gap. That's why firms like Greenwood could make a big difference. It's a black-owned financial institution helping to bring more black families into banking, and it's reinvesting in the black community. Ryan Glover is co-founder and chairman of Greenwood and talked to me about some of the creative ways his firm gives back.
When our members create an account through Greenwood, it provides potentially five meals to a food insecure family through Gooder. Each time you make a purchase, Greenwood rounds up the spare change to support HBCUs through the UNCF.
Glover's Greenwood co-founders are rapper and activist Killer Mike and former Atlanta mayor and U.S. ambassador Andrew Young. I'm Bloomberg's Justin Milliner on the Black Business Beat.
More of the Tory Lowe Show is next on 1017 The Truth, The Truth app, and 1017thetruth.com.
Pop a band on demand. If you're a lap dance, tip for the strip. Strip for the peso. Broad only move if the dollar make us say go. Looking for that hay, or do it till I say so. King of the club, beat the queen of the shake joint. Hitting that with nigga pocket till he hit a break point. I like a mate, made like the mafia, not like no housekeeper. And so much money, I call a street sweeper, night creeper.
Woo! Night keeper. Ice Moan with Kane from the Yin Yang Twins. King of the clubs. New hey, song. That's the Shorty Thick. That's a bump, D-bump,
D-bump. Shorty dick in the mug.
Yeah, hey. That's dude. Yeah, like 20 years ago.
Hey, is that out now on YouTube?
He put it out now. Yeah, he's putting it out there. He giving it to all the DJs. Right
okay.
Now. What? He giving it to all the DJs. So okay. Now we spread the word for him.
That's what's up.
Like cool minions.
He better make a TikTok.
Never lie.
Hey.
Hey, you ain't wrong. Hey, he using Facebook. He using the internet.
Hey, you better get a dance and get some TikTok.
Tap in.
It's a balance. It's
hey,
a balance.
This the new era. You gotta the promotion gotta come with some reels.
It's a balance. You ain't wrong.
Hey.
You ain't wrong. I'm behind.
Well, I appreciate you for introducing that to us.
Appreciate no doubt. You're welcome.
Hey, joining us on the lines is Justice Wisconsin advocate and author Elizabeth Brown. How you doing, Queen?
Salute King, all is well.
Hey, look, we got some guests in the building. We got Doc B in the building, and we got Darren in the building.
What's going on?
Salute.
Scorpio, Sagittarius, still your neighbor. Hi.
There you go with that zodiac. Take it easy, Doc B.
I'm about to tap. I'm tapping out. I'm gonna let y'all have it.
Hey.
Hey, play less.
Hey, Elizabeth, I wanted to get your take on when we talk about the youth and that we talk about arts. Arts has actually been a conversation that they bring up as far as when NPS talk about they want more money, arts, music, and things like that. But, you know, when we talk about the youth, are we really providing the knowledge and the information that's truly needed for them to succeed?
Hell no. Hell to the no, we not. You know, when you think about, you know, again, that's the mission statement that they want, you know, art and things like that when it comes to these children. But at the same time, when you think about where they reading at, you know, the reading level, we talk about basketball and we talk about all of these other things, which if they're reading at a fourth grade level, they're building prisons due to these testing scores. So to have art and all of these extracurricular things when we can't even get them to learn the basics, you know what I'm saying? Like that reading, math, you know what I'm saying? I mean, how do you jump from what the basics is because you're failing there and then, you know, push this ideology that, you know, They need art. Do our children need that? Yes. But again, the foundation of the education has to be built first. Because what do it mean to say we're going to give them art and we're going to give them music in the grades when it comes to what we would call basic education is not there? Again, this opens our children up to be misled by the images that is put forth before them. When we talk about especially black youth, the goal to become a basketball star, a rapper, the ideologies of all of these movies, music, what they push to poor children. You know, again, a child with a fourth grade reading level is easily manipulated to believe the illusions. They're not going to think for themselves. They don't have the ability. They don't have a leg to stand on to speak for themselves. They know that individual with a fourth grade education can be misled into believing whatever somebody else who has a higher education puts before them. That becomes law for them if they only have the ability, you know, to think on a fourth grade level. Somebody who's reading at a 12th grade level can spin these individuals.
Right.
You understand? To believe whatever they want them to believe, which is going to mislead them, again, to believe that they need to do certain things like going into the executive suite with Diddy to get on, to secure the bag.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? To go into these rooms of other individuals who got the chains and the bins in the MTV cribs. And in reality, find out when they do pick the door, what they had to lose to get there is really not worth it. But again, when we're talking about the education level of our children and how they put these mission statements in the front of us, we can no longer go off of the mission statement. The facts of the matter is the fact that our children are reading below where they're supposed to be. The test proves that they continue to build prisons. These prisons for our youth are not rehabilitating our children. They're doping them up, sending them back out here with a fourth grade education, which guarantees them to go back to the prison system that is producing or receiving $1 million a head for each child, because again, these prison systems is privately owned and it's like a hotel. You want to keep the beds full. How do you do that? You perpetuate the same ideologies. Get out, fourth grade education. You can't get a job because, again, you've been labeled. So you come back out into the streets, and now you're battling with the same people that look like you for the crumbs that's on the street, which we know poverty leads to what? Criminality.
And they're saying that.
Which is where else you're going.
They're saying that nearly 16,000 students have been suspended in Milwaukee public schools so far this year, but black students make up.
Yes.
80% of the suspensions.
That part, on top of the fact that now they're saying it's up 6.9% this year in 2024.
Mm.
Okay, and we know that the pandemic, the damage that done, our kids was already behind, you know, sports-wise and everything else. So here you have these individuals who are requesting more money from the people, saying what it is that they need to sustain the broken system as it is. They haven't went to the drawing board and seen, because again, NPS enrolling have declined. And we understand why, because they're failing. However, they haven't went to the table to see, because they're trying to uphold these broken systems. The schools that are declining needs to be shut down. You understand? And that money needs to be put where it's supposed to be put, to benefit our children. But not only that, we need some statistics on the last $87 million that we approved. Where did it go?
Mm.
Who got paid? And prove to us that our children are getting smarter, because just on that article that you just spoke about the suspensions, if they're being suspended, they're not being educated. So I don't care what music class you have. If they're being suspended, how are they getting the music class too?
We got Darren in the building, DT's son. Darren, want to ask you a question?
Yeah, I'm kind of going to play devil's advocate right now. I want to get to the original question of the schools not providing that money for the arts, you know. And I bring that up because certain students, certain kids, they learn through different mediums. And I feel that we do got to keep that in mind, because the same way, you know, a student isn't experiencing or getting the option to experience certain arts, they're able to go play basketball, they're able to go play sports, they're able to go do other things. And I know quite a few people who play sports. They whole high school, middle school, elementary, and they're not that good at math. They don't know how to count their money. They don't know how to do those things.
Right.
And I just want to advocate for the students that, hey, it's a couple people out here that made it musically. It's a couple people that made it out here.
But they don't know how to read the contract.
And they don't know how to read it. And I really say that 360
universal that deal that never ends, and they wind up broke. You can be the devil advocate for that, but in reality, even the ones that did do well in school and did get the contract still die broke, especially when they look like us. When we look at P. Diddy, we look at Kanye West. You understand what I'm saying?
No, you're completely right. But when do we take out that how many people they uplifted on the way and impacted? Because there was a couple of those people that was listening to Kanye's album or was listening to DMX album, and we know how terrible DMX was with his money, but they lit
something. They still like the prayer.
Exactly.
Hey, look, when we come back, Elizabeth Brown, I want to get your final thoughts. Truth Nation. Stay locked in right here on Tory Lowe.
The Tory Lowe Show returns after this on 101.7 The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Truth Nation, Dr. Ken Harris here, and I'm excited about the Truth's partnership with Versity. There is a serious need for blood donations in the Black community, and Versity wants to bring awareness to this because it's their mission to improve patient outcomes, advance the field of personalized medicine, and strengthen the health of communities everywhere. This is why you should tune in every month when a representative from Versity joins the Truth to share about what they're doing to make a difference in our community.
Bucks partial plans are now available for the 2024-25 season. These ticket plans are designed to put the power in your hands. So map out your ultimate game day experiences by selecting the opponents and seat locations that work best for your budget. Immerse yourself in the excitement of hand-picking your Bucks games. Enjoy your choice of thrilling rivalries, cross-conference picks, and matchups between the NBA's greatest. Visit bucks.com/partial to map out your partial plan. That's bucks.com/partial.
You are listening to The Tory Lowe Show on 101.7 The Truth app, and 101.7thetruth.com.
Yo, I go by the name of Pharrell from the Neptunes, and I just want to let y'all know, I'm your pusher.
101.7 The Truth, Tory Lowe Show. Elizabeth Brown, I want to get your final thoughts on the show today. It was a lot going on.
As always, King, it's always a lot going on. You know, it's Milwaukee, but not only that, we in America in a trying time. The bottom line is, you know, we can no longer just throw money. The reality of money and where it's getting individual, especially when it comes to our children, no matter how much money you throw at them, if they don't have the basic necessities, the love, the support, the integrity, when we're talking about schools, of course, they're supposed to be art, because, again, there's more good children than there are, I would consider, that's troubled, you know. But in reality, with the monies that's been given, we have nothing to show for it, especially when it comes to the Black community. And the bottom line is, until we build the foundation correctly, the house don't stand a chance. Period.
I agree. And many times I always tell people, you got to understand the agenda that the money is backing. And many times once you do a little digging, you'll find out that that agenda wasn't supposed to benefit us at all. But I think that we don't look at the root ideas that are motivating, you know, where they're trying to place the money, where they're trying to position the money, and we continue to pour money into something that may have a hole in it. So if the agenda,
the reality,
if the agenda is not to really truly get the work done, we won't see no results. And that's what people are complaining about. They're not seeing any outcomes either way.
Not only that, I mean, when you think about money and everybody who's talking about we need money to do this, that's just like, you know, the so-called misleadership of Milwaukee. They have all the money. They have all these programs. There are all these churches and nonprofits. But Tory Lowe doing all the work with no money. Mm. You understand what I'm saying?
Hey.
You have the results with no money.
Preach.
You understand what I'm saying?
Preach.
So when you go to really thinking about it, we got to move away from materialism and make us understand that we, people make money. Money don't make people. You understand what I'm saying? When you find a value in yourself, then you no longer fall for the fool's gold. And because the people that's really working not getting paid, and the people that's getting paid not working. So,
hey, I would love to pull up in one of them Mercedes at the at the school board.
Hey, they hating on you, fam. It ain't gonna happen.
Hey, drive some of these parents up there. Hey.
Hey, quit falling for the losing. The people that's really working is suffering, and the ones that's not working is half on a vacation. You understand? They hours is cut off. You can't call the mayor. You can't call, you know what I'm saying, none of these individuals who really getting the money. Where is, you know, the so-called head of the public schools? Mm. Nowhere to be found. Again, proving that those that are really doing the work, not the millionaires, we the ones that out here just doing the work.
Mm.
So,
you said a mouthful. Hey, I'm speechless. Hey, I'm good. All right, I appreciate you for tapping in, Queen, as usual, being on the front lines.
That's
it's a lot
right.
of work to do,
Salute
Queen.
Salute to you.
Thank you.
Salute to Darren. Salute to Brother Z. One love.
All right, I'll talk to you soon. All right, DJ Brother Z.
All right, turn it up on the phone. Let's get it.
And look, all right, Darren.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for standing in there with me, co-hosting the show today.
Man, thank you. I appreciate you having me in. Whenever you need me to step in again, you know my hours, dog.
Hey. All right, Truth Nation, look. You know I love you. Be safe. Dr. Ken Harris up next. Even start a world war for these ghetto girls
and boys. I'm rapping around the world for... Truth Nation, it is Denise.